That term may have to, though.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Preparation Ape, number one place for hipster-ass videos of edge case scenarios.
You gotta quit with those.
Nope, we're not gonna do it.
I don't know if you've ever done... Nah, maybe you've done like
no,
two.
No, there was a time when we knew what it was gonna be. Doesn't matter, though. Of course, this is Preparation Ape. Commence live every single Thursday at 8:30 p.m. Central Standard Time at twitch.tv/chainsaw. I'm DKP.
I'm Major Tom.
And we're joined by our special guest this week.
Hey there, I'm Wesley Wright.
Mr. Wesley, how are you?
I'm doing well.
Is that
how
what you want to call you as Wesley?
You can call me whatever I hear.
Cool.
And that works out.
Why don't you tell us a little
just
bit
don't
about
call
yourself.
Me late for dinner!
Yeah.
Every time.
Let's not do that. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself, Mr. Wesley?
I'm a new resident of Austin. I do video game design and production, and you know, I'm just a normal video game enthusiast myself.
So you do production. Do you work for anybody in particular right now, or
no? I'm currently looking for work. Okay, no, cool. I just moved out here.
Cool.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Curtin says I'm well, in Austin so. In 2 days.
John Marston, boys. This is Dirty Raptor.
The Marston fellas.
Why'd you uninstall Grindr in 2 days, Kappa?
Well, there was some guy who was telling me we were streaming on Wednesday. Yeah, well, Mr. Curtin just turned 18, so we installed Grindr, right?
Nice.
And this guy was like, I'm bored and at a hotel, and he's like, you should get a GameCube then.
You should get a GameCube.
So, I don't know, maybe all he was finding was just a bunch of bored men that just wasn't what he was looking for. So what do we got on the Resident Docs tonight, Major T?
Well, interestingly enough, we now have a slide.
Oh, wow. Would you look at that shit?
Bam! So we got a few special TSA announcements. We're gonna, of course, be talking about the two major announcements that came out today. Nintendo Switch and the Red Dead Redemption 2 reveal trailer. Just a couple of topics. Is VR a fad? We're going to talk about that for a little bit. We've talked about it in the past, but you know, now that I have a VR unit in my home, I want to kind of talk about that a little bit. We're also going to be talking about digital versus physical. What do you prefer? Where do you think we're going? Stuff like that. And then we're going to ask the question, do you pre-order? Do you pre-order games? If so, why? Do you think there's a benefit to pre-ordering? Is there a benefit that you see for the business or anything like that? And then finally, we're going to do our Ask Apes Anything. So,
all right.
So we do wearing have wearing shorts today?
Yeah.
Yeah, he is, girl.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, he is. Saw the trailer for Red Dead 2 and I accidentally nutted my pants. That is so sad.
Mr. Curtis said nobody wanted a GameCube, unfortunately.
Agenda slide. Awesome, up, says Bebiv. Yeah.
So, we're going to move right along to some fun and exciting news this week, which we have a second slide for that, I guess.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Yeah, breaking news.
So, this initially was supposed to be like 4 or 5-ish announcements, but one of them got axed, so I'm happy to report.
Yeah.
So one of the things that was going to happen was I was about to start a new work schedule, which would mean that I wouldn't be able to stream as much, which would mean there would be like 2 months at a time that I wasn't going to be able to do Prep Ape. But the coworkers and I, we all worked through it, and that will not be an issue. There may be a couple, I think it's like a month every 7 months that I'll be streaming less, but don't you pull my fucking leg hair. Don't listen to Curtson. He always tries to manipulate. He manipulates the guests.
Arm hair?
Don't you fucking.
Like hair?
Don't you here? Listen to Kurt.
He's telling me to do it. I need fans.
So, that being
Mr. Kurt is not the fan you need.
Oh, but speaking of, Mr. Wesley does have his own Twitch channel, so we're going to plug that here in the chat here.
Ooh. Oh, brilliant.
Is that correct?
There's
I believe?
An underscore in between right and here.
So ignore that one.
But, they can figure it out.
Is that Jay Diggs in the background? Yes, Jay Diggs is Peanut Gallery.
That is me.
Peanut Gallery.
So, you know, even if, worst case scenario, which is no longer a thing, that, you know, you weren't getting to the stream as much, we did have somebody who was willing to sub in, which we will get to that here in just a minute.
Yep.
First bit of breaking news, potentially sad news for some, but overall, this is kind of a Reggie's Law sort of, Golden Reggie sort of news, Dandelander sort of news. I don't know.
It's the first big heartbreak.
Win Stuff Money is no more. They're no longer doing Win Stuff Money.
Yep. So, general idea behind it is, when we thought of the idea of doing Win Stuff Money, we were like, hey, let's entice viewers to come in, play this game, win a $25 Amazon gift card. We'll get people to start coming back. And what we found is that some people would just come in for win stuff money, just for that $25 gift card. Mm-hmm. And then a lot of times it didn't increase our viewer count or keep the viewer count there. So we decided to take the $25 a week or the $100 a month that we were putting into it. And instead, we have decided that we're going to invest in the stream. But we're going to be super transparent about what we are going to spend that money on. Because basically that was money that was your money that we were giving to you guys. So we want to make sure that we're making the stream, the channel, better. So we've already talked about where we're going to put it to start with. So
yeah, so when we do get something new, we'll be letting everybody know. That way they know exactly where the money went.
Yeah. Who's the guy in the middle?
That's Mr. Wesley. Yes. You'll probably see him more on the channel often. He's a good egg.
Yeah.
Video game designer and oh my god.
What's up, Morning Shark? Dude, your dogs.
I know, they're fucking worse.
They're ruining Prep Ape.
Yeah.
They're ruining it.
Oh, they always do. They always do. So yes, like I said, we're no longer doing with stuff money, but you will see the stream steadily improve as a just for example, getting a new camera, like a decent one will be just without win stuff money, 2 months.
Yeah.
Potentially, like, you know, lapel mics.
Yeah, we want to get lapel mics better. Eventually, so.
Which, like I said, it's kind of a weird thing where it's like, hey, we did this thing, and then we take it away. But that's where we're going to be pretty transparent about exactly where the money's going.
Yeah.
Not that we have to, exactly.
It's really weird.
We don't apologize to nobody. It's what we don't do that here in Chainsight. But it's a good trade, I think.
Really weird. You think that giving away, this from Kurt, giving away free money would bring more people in, but it did the opposite. See what we can do about that, Texas Phil Davis.
Yeah.
Jay Digg is talking. He said, can we get Win Stuff Money stickers instead? Definitely. We'll definitely look into it. Maybe we'll get a Win Stuff Money shirt, but you gotta use that WrestleMania font.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Quality. So, yeah, I think that's it on that slide if you want to go to the next announcement.
Yeah, so our exciting news.
I'm gonna have a sub in for this one, so I'm gonna step away.
Yeah.
All right. Not ready for this transition.
Hi, guys. How's it going? All right, so I'm just stepping in because I wanted to announce that we are going to be doing Extra Life this year. On November 5th, we're going to do a 24-hour stream right here at the start of the day, all bright and shiny early at 12 a.m. all the way to 12 a.m. We are going to be playing games all day and all night for your viewing pleasure. We're also going to be trying to raise money through donations through Extra Life. More information to come as we build up our website for that. And, of course, we will give all the details in our group on Chainsaw 8, or the Chainsaw 8 group on Facebook, and anywhere else that we can. We're going to be plugging it until we get there, November 5th. And if you have any questions or anything like that, put it in our group, and I'll be happy to answer. All right.
All this goes to charity, not us. Quick.
What is Extra Life?
Extra Life is a donation site that promotes people to play video games to earn money for children's hospitals. The Miracle Network. If you have a chance, check it out. It's pretty awesome. It's play games, heal kids. We are going to be sponsoring the Dell Central Texas.
Play games, feel kids.
Heal.
Hell yeah.
Heal kids.
Oh. Calm down.
I know, he got real excited about that.
Back out? No, I misheard you from the beginning on this.
I'll take over your spots.
Right, it's really exciting, and it's awesome that we're going to have a chance to do this. if you guys have any particular games you'd like us to play or anything like that, please let us know, because it's going to be a lot of fun. And all of the Chainsaw Ape family will be there. And the dogs, too. Clearly. Yes, and JD will answer your question in like 3 days. Yes, it will. It might be a little while, but as soon as I have the information, I'll be happy to provide it for you, Idify. You bitter. You salty. He's a little salty.
Is he always salty?
Oh, he's always salty. That's the one who came in and was like, who's that guy?
Bro.
If you had been here at the start of the stream, you might know who he is, Idify.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to give you guys back Major Tom. That's who you're really here to see tonight. So.
Playing a Ghostbusters game. Nope. All right, so... What's that?
Go to the next slide.
Potentially our biggest announcement?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. We got the return of the Angry Tomato. But this time he stays for good.
I'm staying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Part of the Chainsaw crew, the cast.
Cool, yeah, come on in.
I'm officially an ape. An angry one.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I guess like some ape tomato.
Here's the thing. I'm always going to call you tomato.
I know, dude.
Period. But, since you're Joan, I mean, what do you want to be referred to as, officially?
I mean, you know, I'm all about that senpai. But, all right. You know, senpai Arkham, but, I mean, come on. Whatever you guys call me, I'll just respond to.
Okay, so I guess it's up to everyone else, right?
Besides Idify.
I mean,
let's not leave it up to Idify.
We know the answer, right? All right, so what do you think you can bring to Chainsaw? What do you say? What would you say you do here?
All right, come on, let's.
Are you the people person?
Let's be real here. I'm here to bring the memes. You know?
Oh yeah.
It's kind of what I do in my day, dude.
Oh yeah,
So you're the memalier.
Everyone's excited about that Tomator being here, man.
No, I'll probably be doing like a lot of like 3DS games, like Pokemon, JRPGs, Magic the Gathering, stuff like you guys normally don't do. Bringing in a new scene to the crowd.
Yeah, potentially possibly Saturday streams, or if Tom has any complications with scheduling, and there will be weekly streams, possibly with both of us, or maybe combination, and some also Tomato solo streams. Yes.
Sweet.
So, yeah, big announcement there. Hope you guys like the artwork we did there. Yeah, spent a lot of time on that. Turn of the Angry Tomatoes. It used to be Killer Tomatoes. I don't know if you know that. Great movie.
Oh.
Allegedly.
Never watched it.
I love the change.
I don't know. George Clooney was in it.
So, yes, I'm sure he'll bring various shades of red, Mr. Kirkman says. Yes, you will. So, all right. That's our big announcement for today. That's our most exciting one to me.
Goodbye, gents.
I love me some Tomatoes.
Yay! Welcome, Tomatoes!
All right, so say we get the fuck into it, because we do have quite a bit to talk about today.
And we're probably going to be on these few slides for the next, like, 3 hours, so.
Oh, God, I fucking hope
not. Yeah, it's possible.
Oh, Jesus.
So, last night, Nintendo, rumors have been circulating that the NX was going to be officially revealed either this week or next week. Last night, Nintendo tweeted out saying, hey, tomorrow morning, we're going to have the first trailer for what the NX actually is. And then this morning at, I think it was 9 a.m. Central Standard Time.
No, it was 9 a.m. on the nose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was looking at my computer countdown clock. And the second it hit 9 a.m., I refreshed it there, so.
Yeah. Nintendo revealed the NX to be the Nintendo Switch. So we're going to watch the trailer. We're going to go through a couple of details on things that we've seen. And we're going to talk about it for a while, about if we're excited about it or our general thoughts on it, so.
Yes.
Just to hit a couple of comments before we do that. Boo, Tomato, says I.
Boo, Tomato, boo.
If he's not salty, you're not doing it right.
Well, alright.
Better be some goddamn Miracle Whip there. No Miracle Whip here.
Spotify says, if I was there, I would throw himself at himself.
Like, if I was there.
Tomatoes, get
it?
Is this a fucking going, man?
Little Tortilla Boy says, proudest fap I've had in my life, all thanks to Nintendo.
Never be ashamed.
Someone in the group said the controller is made for people with baby hands, and they are correct.
It's like Deadpool.
It does look like that.
It's like Deadpool.
You gotta have them. You gotta have them little baby hands.
Well, we'll get to that and many more.
Let's start with this right with the reveal now, trailer.
Oh my fucking god! I asked BKP to put her the fuck up, and I guess she's like, nah, it's not. So we're gonna have a more Wednesday, more screaming.
Classic.
But I guess the rest of Prep Ape. You know, this super special Prep Ape. Alright, so I'll go ahead and pause it a little bit.
I knew
from the very beginning what the fuck we were getting into when we saw this trailer.
Can we maximize it if we're gonna pause it all the way through?
Yeah.
Is that possible?
Yes.
Theoretically.
Maybe not.
Yeah, no, we can. Hold on. I have to fucking do this. Gosh, chicken shit bullshit. Return of the tabs.
Oh, we probably should have done it this way to begin with. Hey,
man, fuck my ass. I'm sorry, these fellas. We don't run that tight of a ship here, as I'm sure you can tell. All right.
LOL, middle guy.
His new name is born. All right, I'll take it.
What new name is
that?
A middle guy.
Middle guy.
I didn't give you a name.
That's fair.
Me and Major Tom were the only two people that got to pick on their hips. Everyone else has been given one. You know, you only thought you did. Alright. So, there you go.
The
so, freaking, let's stop talking real quick. What do you think of the Switch name?
I don't get it. Quite yet.
You don't get it, or you don't like it? Because it makes sense.
What am I switching from my mid-TV to my handheld?
There's like these console names always have multi meanings, and there's two primary meanings that I'm getting out of this. Number one.
Oh, really? What are the Wii? What was the meaning of the Wii?
There's a bunch of them. They talked about it. Wii in French means yes, which is like a very positive term. Wii in America or English means like a collective group of people.
Okay.
So Wii is a what is it? An onomatopoeia where it's like Wii.
Yeah.
They've said that.
So like, what I was literally making fun of, there's no way it was that. What does Wii U mean then?
Wii U means we have no idea what we're doing.
Okay, thank you.
Then what is Switch? We didn't know what we were doing, and now we kind
of
think
we do. The 360 is like, this will be like 360 degrees of your life will be around this in some capacity. It's like playing online with friends, and the one is all of your devices into one console.
I really just prefer the PlayStation 2, where it's like, hey, it's like that, but number two.
It's the second one.
It's the sequel.
Yeah, for sure.
That's our PlayStation. I like how they kept it that way.
It should have been called PlayStation 2 Electric Boogaloo.
It should have been. We'll get to that later. All right, so we got a couple people saying Switch is fine. They like NX better. Yeah. That was kind of what I was saying.
Everybody always talks like about NX, that with code man. Names. NX it's a code name.
Cool. I know that, but fuck it. Yeah, at some point, they could have just been like, yeah, the NX just really sounds great. Let's just stick with it. I know it started as a code name, but fuck it. Everyone knows what it is. People like it.
I mean, Scorpio sounds badass. I can't wait for that to come out. And that's just a...
That's a code
brand name. Yeah, it's a code name. Yeah, so, code name. If they just called it that when it launches,
had the GameCube, PlayStation Gemini, or the PlayStation,
the GameCube
Cancer.
Was the Dolphin, yeah.
Right?
The Wii was the Revolution.
Well, the Scorpio is going to be called Project Scorpio. Cafe. Like, that's the name. That's not the project title.
That's the project name.
It's the project name.
You're fucking with me. No. Okay, I thought that was the actual reveal name.
No, it might end up being it, but as far as we know, it's it's a Project Scorpio.
So you got that from playing Mario to watching ISIS beheading videos. You can do it all, baby.
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, a little Tortilla Boy said, I hate my friends. What the hell would I want to play with? So, let's see. Sure. Word baby.
That huge ass screen on the handset is going to get broken so fast being portable. Yeah, they're going to...
Which, there's a lot of moving pieces in this. Yeah, right. That's...
Right, yeah. There's a lot of moving pieces, so... GameStop's gonna make hella money just doing.
I mean, if they sell.
Assuming you can get it from GameStop.
Yeah, exactly. It may be one of those things you can only buy from the website, like an additional hard drive. Or
I can't wait to get the Mad Cats fucking side controllers. Yes, it's gonna be great.
Do you think they will come out with like alternative like controller pieces?
Somebody will find a way.
I hope they do.
Hey, check it out! This one's an actual sword, and you like snap a sword in.
I'd be about it.
While you play.
So, yeah, let's keep moving.
So, yeah, just to touch on the name real quick, actually, before we keep...
makes me
to me, Switch means you can switch it from a home console to a portable console. Right?
No, it... Yeah,
that's a little on the nose, don't you think?
But Switch, you were talking about you didn't really know what it means. That's what it means.
I didn't say I know what it means.
No, not you.
I was.
Oh, okay. Like, Switch to me like almost sounds like that would be an accessory.
Yeah.
Nintendo Switch. Like, oh, it's a Switch of some sort. So I think...
You talk back to your grandmother, and she's like, go get me that Nintendo Switch.
Said earlier, boy, go get yourself a Switch.
Yeah.
Then you're going to get your ass beat.
Horn to Mario, Switcheroo.
It's actually get the called name, a Switch, but I hate it. Beat people.
It makes me think of a Nintendo brand Switchblade.
And it's also, Nintendo is switching up their game plan and getting away from the Wii and going to something different.
They should switch hands, whichever one's holding the gun in their mouth, because they're not pulling the trigger well enough.
Whoa.
Moving on, fellas. Alright, so let's take a look at this thing. So we got multiple HDMI ports. And
Are those HDMI ports or are those USB?
I don't care.
Well, you should care.
I mean...
Well, it's going to have both, probably.
As someone who was talking a lot of shit, but is guaranteed to own one.
The stand
looks
nice.
Well, that's why it's
nice.
Like, why am I even here? Like, yeah. They got me by the...
Why do we even do this?
They got me by the balls. Like, I want to play new Mario.
Right, right.
They do have you by the balls.
So why am I even here?
So...
Yeah, the console dock does look good.
Yeah.
I do like that.
I think it's legit. Yeah.
What do you guys think about the actual Switch logo?
I'll tell you, colors. That looks kind of shady. Like, I don't
know. TKP, you're the left one and I'm the right one.
He doesn't look... Yeah, I guess so.
Can I be that line in the middle?
Yeah, you can be the line in the middle.
All
right. You're middle guy, right?
So yeah, you're middle
works,
guy.
Man. What I do like about it is that unlike the Wii U, I don't feel like it's going to slide the fuck off my cat walks up there.
Without a doubt.
Yeah. yeah, I mean, as far as like the I guess you'd call it a gradient or like lightly spray-painted look. I don't know. I think that's to appeal to the other people that they show, they think their demographic is in this trailer. You know, that almost like stencil-esque look to it.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I don't dislike it.
No, I think it's fine.
Yeah. Now this thing, pause there.
Yeah.
So, this is what I assume is what it's going to come with. Whenever you... you buy it, it's going to come with this. Whatever this little controller port thing is. Which it looks like, it reminds me of the Jaguar controller. Remember the Jaguar controller? Yep. Sure. It looks like a Jaguar controller. It's like a big square. But it's going to have like two grips. See the grips? Well, you actually can't see it from this angle. But the grips are kind of on the back.
So we don't really know what the thing in the middle is. People were saying that charges the actual... Like, that's a battery that you charge when you put it on there. It charges like the... Actual, like,
the remote parts.
What do they call the Joy-Cons?
They're called Joy-Cons.
Joy-Cons.
Sounds like a terrible rap name.
Hey, you going to, girl, you going to Joy-Con this year, bro? Yeah,
I'm going to Joy-Con.
I don't know.
It's gonna be so much fun.
I feel like I should be everybody going will to be Joy-Con. So happy.
Pep says that thing is gonna break so easily. It could.
I hope could. Not.
It's gonna come with hipster with this hipster music.
I think that will. Especially for people that have kids, like, be afraid. Be very fucking afraid. Well, all the parts you could lose?
Potentially. Ooh. I'll let you know, as someone who has a small child.
All the little slots where it slides in and out are just going to collect so much crap in kids' hands.
I have a feeling, though.
I hope they click super fucking loud like a gunshot.
Dude, that's what I want. But like,
because it keeps showing the thing in the trailer. Which will,
yeah.
And it has to be loud as fuck. I gotta wake up my
There's a certain there's neighbors. A certain joy that like sounds can give you.
Oh, without
there's
a doubt.
There's a certain feeling that you can get when something sounds
the other thing is,
I feel like the sound of like snapping those in and out is just
listen, like it lets me know that, hey, this is connected for real. Yeah. That's the confirmation of like when you pull back the slide on a gun in a game, you hear that.
Hopefully it comes with guns that you can slide in and like, shoot while you play. That sounds awesome.
So yeah, we will see in the side. Do you want to have a comment? Couple comments real quick, Mitch T.
Yep. No, do I want to? Lotro T Boy says, I have a Joy-Con. Kappa.
Nice.
Idify says, too much middle conversation going on right now. It's called cross-talking, fucking bitch. Love you, Idify.
It's got you dead to rights, baby.
Pebiv says, we will get to have the joy of blowing in the slot again. Classic Nintendo.
Hey, you know what? Now that when you put it that way, I'm all for it.
Yeah.
Never mind.
I can't wait to blow Nintendo. I think that for Nintendo's latest gimmick console, it's pretty bearable.
We're going to get to that. The this is a step in the right direction sort of talk. We'll get to that.
Hold on to that.
Yeah.
You know what I like, says little Tortilla Boy? Steak sizzling on the grill. Now that's a sound I can get.
Hopefully
behind.
It doesn't explode on you like a note. Hopefully it does. Hopefully it explodes on me, that way I can retire.
That would be nice.
So you clearly can undock your game from your television.
I like docking all right.
Take it home, or take it outside.
Yeah, sure. What you got?
So if walking your dog's too mundane,
also
bring your video games. If the nice sunrise is too mundane,
oh, you know what? I just
bring your video games.
I just kind of figured it out. So everyone was saying, "What the fuck does that little D-pad do?"
It's a plus sign.
It's not. Yeah, it's not like a D. It's not a D-pad.
No, it's the plus sign and the minus sign.
Yeah, from like the Wii and the Wii U.
Right.
Because they can't put it in the middle.
And then you can see the minus sign on the joystick so much.
You don't like the offset joysticks?
I don't.
Dude, I fucking hate the ones like on the Wii U Pro Controller where it's up both top.
I love them when they're
up here. I hate that so much. It'd be cool to have like they probably will have customizable ones where like you can get two of the same one on on that side.
Angry Tomato, Angry Tomato. What can you say?
I mean, why would they? If it has customizable parts, you can slide it in, slide it out. I would imagine they would. Now, how much of it's going to fucking come standard? Who knows? But,
I like how thin the mobile part is, says Little Tortilla Boy. Idify says, is that what they told you to say? GameStop rep?
Yes.
Yeah. Lord Barbecue says, have you apes touched on hardware specs yet? We have not.
Because we don't have any. Yeah, we have very little.
There are some hardware specs that are out there, but...
But nothing that tells us anything, like, really...
NVIDIA has posted some stuff on it. Yeah. Jay Digduck says, do you think Nintendo is going to sell the controller pieces separately? Or cap on the tiny pieces and make everyone purchase a complete controller.
Ladder.
One piece is damaged.
100%.
Yeah, the ladder. You're going to have to buy the full controller. Kurt says, which mode do you think people will use more at home? The better Wii U or that weird controller brick? I'm going to use that, probably, the actual tablet. I'll probably use that more than... I'll probably play it on that more than I will on the television.
Yeah, I think so.
I play my Wii U more on the gamepad than I do on the television. Just because it's nice to be able to, like, multitask, put episode of Cheers on in the background.
Right.
Play some fucking Paper Mario. Yeah.
It's all right. I hate this fucking music, by the way.
Shock.
It's just, it's so hipsterish and douchebaggish. Just like the rest of this fucking commercial.
I don't travel a lot, or very much at all for that matter, but I'm very excited about the idea of having something like that while waiting in a line or sitting on a plane. Ooh, look at that little kickstand. It's gonna break off real quick.
Oh, it's got a headphone jack.
See,
then you can use it like the Wii controllers where you have one in each hand.
I really like how... No, okay, so we mentioned Skyrim. And to briefly pause it to go over this, Bethesda said, we're not unveiling what games are coming out.
We're not making any announcements on if Skyrim is actually on this thing.
Yeah, so it very well just fucking couldn't be.
But we are partnering with Nintendo for the Nintendo Switch.
Yeah. Let's see, Mr. Kurtzen says, I don't think anyone at Nintendo has ever walked a dog. A dog would constantly be tugging on your arm, which would screw up with your gameplay. And lord, and no. Let's see. Tortilla Boy says, now that cartridges are confirmed, I'm hoping that the DS and 3DS lineup will be back. Which
I think I read that they won't be.
Yeah, of course they won't be. Why would they be?
I think it's a different size cartridge.
It's a different size cartridge, but it also...
I don't think it has a touchscreen.
No,
I think no.
You haven't shown anyone touching on the screen.
Yes,
they've confirmed that it's a 10-point touchscreen.
10-point?
Yeah.
How do you touch something?
Who the fuck is Renee Zellweger?
Put all 10 fingers on there and go, ah,
what do you mean by 10-point touchscreen?
It can
touch 10 points at one time.
It can touch 10 points at one time, identified.
So that's weird that they didn't show any of that in the trailer. They didn't have anyone like swiping or pushing or anything.
Well, maybe they're trying to move away from that gimmick.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's actually a big part of it is how they market this thing matters. And if they show people like swiping, they're like, oh, is it touchscreen?
Right.
It's part of that. It's
playing devices. Yeah, there's a particular audience that they're chasing after. Well, as you can see, that no one under or over the age of... It's like between 20 and 25 is every single person in this commercial.
So this entire commercial, to me, is Reggie's Law. Which we'll get to that here in a little bit.
Yeah, let's wait till we're done with it first.
All right.
They did say it would have Amiibo support. Yes, they did.
That's and we'll good. Actually
pause Very it quickly, DKP explained the Renee Zell... We make good all the time, so we probably should. It's a Chappelle Show reference where... Trading spouses, black guy goes to white guy's home, and whatever. He's taking a shit, Dave Chappelle, and he's like, who the fuck is Renee Zellweger reading one of that? That's it.
Dang reference.
Okay, pause. Go back.
Oh,
go back.
Jesus.
Go back just a little bit. We gotta get that Nintendo Switch Pro controller.
Love it.
Yep.
So...
You see? Okay, yeah, you go.
So, to me, it looks like a combination... of an Xbox 360 controller, but also like a Steam controller. Like it looks thick and bulky. It also has the grips, like a PlayStation 4 controller at the bottom. But look how large the A, B, and XY buttons are. And then also, you can't really see it here, but there are like four buttons above the left joystick and above the right joystick. There are
four
buttons.
Well, we can point them out. There's uno, dos, tres, cuatro.
Yeah. So I think that's interesting. I'm not sure what all four of those or four of those buttons would do. The D-pad looks larger, which I'm really happy about because I want that D-pad to feel nice.
Yeah.
It looks great. The joysticks look comfortable. I'm very excited.
No,
it's what you would want in a controller.
Yeah. It has that offset like you like.
Yeah. It looks like the PS4 and Xbox had an incest child.
Yep.
Yeah. I can agree with that.
You know, never mind. We'll get to this. Oh,
does
man.
Does it come with that where left off on that game that hasn't been announced yet?
That's 5 years old.
Dude, that's snap.
All right, I'll tell you what part of the trailer I hate most. Which is right. I'll show you. Hold on. I hate this part the fucking most.
Look at this guy.
Like, this part, I hate it. It's the worst.
It's like all the controllers I've ever used. Fucked. Dude. And this was the result. Okay, I want to talk about this for a second. Do you see how it is attached to an arm that's sticking out of, like, a chair? So this is, like, some sort of additional device that you can buy to, like, attach it to the actual part of your chair and then attach it in and be able to play it. You want to talk about the controllers for a little bit?
Yes, I absolutely do. I'm sure, like, as I was watching this, I was like, there's no point in making this reference, because it's already been made in the comments, I'm sure. And I watched it at 9 o'clock a.m. Like, what is this, a controller for ants?
Yeah.
It needs to be at least 3 times this size. Like, right. That is so fucking absolutely tiny.
Yeah, it is.
I mean,
if you compare it like they're playing on an actual TV, it's a very small TV, too. So yeah, it's a TV for ants. This particular setup, I don't think is something that
this
people
particular
will be spending
part
a lot of,
does not sell me.
I don't think it's a part that is going to like get a lot of people playing, but I think it's going to be one of those features that we're going to be surprised at, like how much we actually use something. Like I could see myself, like, well, you and I are sitting here while DKP was playing Battlefield.
We could play.
You and I could sit here and play Mario Kart.
Yeah,
and I would be totally fine because
I would love to sit.
It feels like a small portable experience.
I mean, that's kind of what we're doing now.
That'd be great, just like these guys.
Honey, I shrunk the console.
I do want to comment.
As you can see, like these guys mean fucking business.
Yeah, dude.
Pause it back on the screen. You see the screen again.
That's the face of business if I've ever seen it.
The guy on the left is like, what the fuck is happening?
You mean like low rent Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yeah, that's
the guy on the right.
Okay,
so do you want to talk about Mario Kart for a second?
What about it? Oh,
just
the fact
based on what we're seeing here.
That doesn't look like Mario Kart 8 at all.
So there were rumors that they were porting Mario Kart 8 to the NX, now Switch. But this doesn't look like that. I mean, it looks like it from a visual perspective, but what makes it stand out to you?
King Boo's in it.
Yeah,
which is not a character, and then the fact that you can double up on items is not something they've done since I think Double Dash.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so that all looks pretty sweet to me.
Yeah,
it's very exciting.
Well, actually, I think we can actually get like closer screen. Oh, maybe not.
A lot of people.
I thought we got closer screen at foot. Ah, of course, we have to go back to seeing that again.
A lot of people put out that it looks like a same map, but.
Yeah,
I mean they've been doing throwback maps for a long time.
It's the Yoshi circuit map, but like that is like there's a lot of ways they could play this.
Yeah,
they could
the
play
Yoshi
it as
circuit
the
was
NX version, Dash, and then the rest of its DLC, right. Like a separate game mode. There's really no way to tell. But
yeah.
If you're a big fan of Mario Kart, too. This is something that
right. It definitely piques my interest. That's for sure.
I love Pep's got Honey, I Shrunk the Console.
Yeah, that one's good.
Mr. Kurtzen was saying, and his tiny controls look frail as shit. Hold on, I'm gonna show up more. For T-Boy says, what I like about this whole trailer is how everyone is an adult. Feels more mature. We'll get to that in a second.
I guess.
I disagree a little bit. Ms. Gurdon says, I hope they sell the screen separately from the consoles. You don't have to show that. They don't. That is the console.
No, yeah.
So I hate to break it to you.
That is the console.
They don't.
All the power comes from the actual tablet.
I was expecting Sinbad to make an appearance in the teaser trailer.
I want to touch on Little Tortilla Boy's comment that you disagree with. About however was an adult.
Well, it doesn't show the whole family thing.
I think that's the big thing. Which, it's like, it doesn't show, if you look at previews for the Wii U, it would be like a bunch of kids and their dad, or it's grandmothers
and
kids.
Listen, I agree with it.
Like,
they're specifically
targeting an audience here that they didn't target in the past.
I agree what he means in that respect. Like, it's no longer geared towards kids. However, I do not think anybody who's in their actual demographic is in this fucking advertisement here. I still don't think they get who their demographic is.
I think they could have shown.
I think they're angling
of like all of
those
demographics.
I know, but that's what I think it is. I think they're specifically pointing towards a demographic. I'm not saying that particular demographic is the ones that are the most into it, but I can say
so
that this is their goal.
Our market research has shown 90% of people who play our console look like they come out of Infamous 2.
Infamous Second Son.
Yeah, whatever. It's like
because 2, they're all like Louisiana people.
Fine. I think, sure. We'll go over it in its entirety afterwards. But we're just taking the technical specs here. So yes, let's take a look. What's presented here, visually.
Then you go, you race, and then you go. Let's.
They keep doing this, like, hey. You're into riding go-karts, right? Well, ride go-karts before you ride go-karts. And then it's like, hey, you like basketball, right? Play basketball after you basketball. These scenarios have literally never happened. Ever. Not ever. You know?
Can you pause it here?
Yeah.
Are they wirelessly networking?
Yes.
That's
the vibe that I get. Like, you can do it through 3DS, how you can bunch of people can like play the same game.
Give me your 16-digit player code and your 16-digit code.
That's a possibility. I don't think that's going to happen this time, but that's definitely a possibility.
Yeah, we'll see, man.
I think once
that looks exciting.
Even that's a small price to pay for that. I'd say that's really cool.
I don't know
how the fuck we're going to stream this necessarily.
Right.
Well, you just stream it through the TV through an HDMI cable.
Yeah, I guess so. You'd have to have it mounted though.
Do what?
You would have to have it.
Yeah.
Mounted.
Yeah, I can't imagine us. I mean, I guess we could do it to where one of us is playing on the TV and then the other one has a separate gamepad.
I was just saying, I don't know how logistically that's going to work. But...
it works just like every other.
I took my console to every street ball game.
You will now.
Go back to the full shot of the guy holding the controller right before the go-karts. Right before the go-karts. Okay, so there's... that's what we wanted to see. I hate hearing that part. Oh, my God. We're trying so hard. God, it's so quick. Trying so hard to have a good time.
There's a reason they're just showing you a brief little second. You still fucking missed it.
All right, I got it for real this time, fellas.
4-hour prep ape. Just him trying to get this controller part right.
All right.
Nice.
Get it, boys.
Nice.
I did it.
First try.
So, yeah, it's the joystick. He's playing with the right piece. The piece that's on the right-hand side of the tablet. But the joystick, so since they're offset...
He just flipped it.
It's basically in the middle of the controller.
Huh.
So, I don't know how comfortable that's going to be. I can't imagine it being super comfortable. Only time will tell.
Yeah, someone's going to get mad and throw that tiny thing. It's going to sound like this. Ah! Hopefully you could hear that.
Look how small it is. It looks like... It's seriously like the size of his thumb.
Yeah.
Think about how big two of your thumbs are. That's about.
I understand, you want the joypad, joysticks, kind of halfway down one.
Yeah.
But so you got this much space. Imagine playing Mario Kart,
To be honest, I felt the same way with the Wii remote when I first started playing games like that.
But at least then you have how much?
But I'm just saying. I remember it feeling really small.
This dude's probably bumping thumbs.
Well, probably bring Pro controllers and connect it.
Do you want to bump thumbs?
I would like nothing more than to bump thumbs.
Ooh. My dick is bigger than when
Batman says, luckily I have small hands. Hey. All right, so let's get back to where we were here. Yeah, that's never happened ever, this scenario. We're playing basketball under a bridge.
That's because the Switch hasn't ever been out.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what?
Yeah, that's they're showing us the future.
They're going for you guys.
Let's take a break. Before we break, let's do more basketball.
We're having so much fun.
It looks like a good basketball game.
Batman says Nintendo products are usually durable, though. It might be able to take some damage. That's actually a very good point.
Yeah, true.
This I hate the most. Not what we're about to see, but this scenario.
Okay, I want us to get some good pauses here. That's a good pause. Which is just unpause.
Pause.
That controller. Yep.
It looks like it's charging both sides.
Yeah, there's little lights on it. I didn't notice that.
I mean, they expect you to take it everywhere.
Right.
So, yeah. Of course, that's very cool that it charges both sides. But that is the weird thing, oh man, my right side's about to die. Fuck.
I guess I'm not strafing anymore.
You know, I don't know. I just don't know how the fuck this is going to work.
The bottom of it has, grips, rounded grips.
So it's a bulky controller.
Yeah, it's bulky.
I like it.
Alright. So, what we do see here, which is pretty cool here, right? New Mario game.
We get popped on one of those Mario.
Of course, I get two different one of the Marios.
Okay. So you and I talked on the phone earlier.
She's got amiibos here too.
Yeah, she has amiibo. That's actually really important.
She's got
a dove.
She has
some unlit
candles, which means if you're not gonna light them, what the fuck do you have in there?
So
changing screen, which that doesn't look like it'd be a very good one.
She's just a really good interior decorator.
So you and I were talking on the phone about what kind of Mario game this would be. To me, seeing it, it looks like a sequel to Mario 64 or Mario Sunshine. And there's a couple different reasons why. Right, if you rewind it and play it again. Watch Mario jump. 1, 2, 3. He does the triple jump. The triple jump is not something that is in non-3D Mario.
But this is like Super Mario 3D World shit. These rings right here?
Potentially.
Sure.
So we don't really know.
And you just see him do the long jump there. So he does moves that are specific to more 3D-based Mario. Where are her cats, is Kirsten? Looks like the kind of person to have cats.
We're about to see her cats. They're gonna be
she
on the roof.
Totally has cats.
She's got so, cats on the roof.
As far as the world is concerned, this looks like a super festive area. I don't know if this is like a world hub or like a main
like
hub level.
Like a characterized version of Rio.
So I picture Mario like jumping into a painting or something like that and going to this type of world. And then jumping into a painting and going into the type of world that we're about to see here in a second that looks kind of like a castle area.
Sure.
So he's got the triple jump. And he's got the long jump. Look at the clouds and the lighting effects in the sky. Like this looks like the
skybox looks nice.
Yeah. This looks like it was made on a newer visual engine. This is the type of game. I'm actually more excited to see Mario than I am the actual Switch. Because this is the kind of Mario game I want. This is what I've been clamoring for since Sunshine. So, yeah. Super excited. Thoughts?
No, I completely
agree. I want
agree.
To hear more about it. I want to know what it is before I get hyped.
Yeah.
Because that could be, like, if you back it up 2 seconds, right? I can point out a couple things here. Like, this is very Galaxy-esque.
Sure.
Like, there was large areas like this in Galaxy. Like, it could be Mario Galaxy 3.
But the fact that the world is flat shows me that it's not.
Because this is also a scenario which will happen a lot.
Maybe they're just bigger.
Galaxies. Have you ever had friends call you from a roof in your $10,000 a month apartment in Manhattan? It's like, come on over, we're grilling on the roof, and you just wish
come
you had
on
your,
over.
You just wish you had we'll your video game console. Well, now you fucking can.
It's also thin. You see how thin it looks?
Yeah, it does look very thin.
You know, I expected the whole time like her to stuff it in a purse or something. Like, walking across the street just with this fucking thing, like...
She's trying to Pokemon Go.
Hey, friends, could you rob me, please? This would be great. Hey, guys!
What's this?
Oh, if it's got GPS and I can Pogo on it, I'd be all about it.
This is what you want to do, right?
And look at the one girl in the background, like, why are we doing this?
I can't wait to get my paycheck at the end of today.
And, like, Nintendo knew what they were doing with, like, the Red Solo Cups, like,
Look, we're drinking.
Thanks, man. So much fun. I get you're so really cool. Fucking stoked.
Look at my multicolored hoodie, I'm so hip.
And dude, this is the other thing. All right, look, strategically we're gonna have to move in Splatoon. This is the goofiest fucking thing I've ever seen. No, it's not. Cool. No, it's not.
I mean, it's cool, but I don't see people doing this on the ground.
But regardless, if you see people doing it, it
I think if you're gonna fly out to a
this
competition,
this is another.
So true.
Yeah, this is another one of those things that it's like this has literally never happened.
You know,
and it won't happen. And it's not because
no reason for it to.
You could sit on the ground before and do this shit. No.
Dude, have you been to a convention? There's like 80,000 nerds sitting on the floor playing
this
DS.
This is not a convention.
This is two pro teams going against each other on an event.
Yeah, but they've never had like tablets like this to be able to play games while on the
floor. But why are they all on the floor and empty?
Because it's an anywhere
rooms.
Device. Like, I could sit on the floor. We could sit on the couch.
Tell
wherever
me,
you're comfortable.
You once told me. By once, I mean like 2 hours ago. This could be a piece of shit and I would defend it.
That is 100%
true,
yes.
Just give it to me on this one. That's fucking dumb. Nobody's gonna do that.
No, I'm not gonna give it to you. I'm not gonna give it to you.
I think the marketing people tried to, like, go a little too hard on this scene.
Yeah, this is goofy and it's fucking... Nobody does... It's like the basketball
Nobody
scene.
Does it yet.
Yeah, they're changing the game. I want to be uncomfortable when I.
Hey, they're about to get super comfortable. Yeah, they're practicing for this.
We all brought our. All right, guys. This is fucking lame. As when it's like next up, Pawn Stars, and all three of the dudes turn around and do. This is so fucking lame. Yeah, guys. This is more than just playing a video game.
So
this is intense.
Go back to Splatoon real quick. So one of the things we talked about earlier is. It's going to have different versions of, like, they talked about ports coming. So they talked about Smash coming, Smash Brothers, Mario Maker,
new hairstyles,
Mario Kart, and Splatoon. Yeah, so this looks like the old Splatoon, but there are legitimately new hairstyles.
I would
like,
rather
a lot of
it just be Splatoon 2, like, give me a legit update with new maps and everything.
I'm pretty sure we're going to get that, because there's also a new map in this one as well.
Okay.
You can see a new map.
Mr. Batman says, me and my friends have went to bars and looked at our 3DS. There's like five of us. See, that's different, though. I don't know. Then like, we have a chalkboard on the ground. Guys, in our Splatoon game, you're going to go. It's like a football fucking plan. Like, and then they're like, all right, good thing we have a 3DS here. Or fucking, yeah. That's, no, something's different about that.
To me, I think you're blowing this way out of proportion.
No, well, this is fucking lame.
You're blowing it way out of proportion.
Text when he says, hey, what do kids do nowadays? Like, guys wearing uniforms, might be a pro team. Yeah, throw that shit in there. I'm gonna love Mr. Kurtzen. If you play this at a convention, you're gonna have strange come, oh, let me play and just walk off part of your controller. Just gonna pocket
fuck
it,
yeah!
Like,
yeah!
They're gonna pocket it like a big lighter.
Yeah, it's you know? Exactly like stealing a, or someone's borrow a pencil in school.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's, oh man. Alright. We're almost over this thing. We can get over it.
You know, if I can hope for anything, it's maybe they'll bring back the LAN party. Somebody said that to me like right after they watched the show. They're like, oh man, it's like bringing LAN parties back.
I mean, I'd be about that.
Yeah. I would totally be about that. Nintendo Switch.
I do like that snap. The more I hear it, that snap sounds so nice.
It better sound like that in real fucking life.
Yeah.
Or something similar. I better be able to hear it. I'm dead serious.
Yeah. Let's go to the next slide.
Rub it in.
All right. Oh, that breast of a child gameplay. Hell yeah, baby. All right. So back to not having to full screen it. All the features.
So here's just like a bunch of different screenshots from it, and it's kind of outlining a few of the things in a closer proximity. So you can see in the top left the dock with the name, the Nintendo Switch console and the Nintendo Switch dock. So the console itself is the tablet. You see, of course, the screenshot with what the internet is dubbing as Karen.
Karen?
Yeah, they're calling her Karen.
Okay.
Playing Mario. You see a shot of him playing it outside, so it gets you can play it in the house. You can play it outside.
If it looks that nice and that type of lighting, I'm already sold.
There is
sold.
No fucking
I'm already
way.
Sold.
There is no fucking way it will look that good with that type of lighting. Who's the guest star at chat? This name is Middle Guy. He's also a GameStop representative.
The game cards look great.
Yeah, and then it's small.
Yeah.
You can see that, like, for the 3DS and the DS, the part that actually shows the chips, the little bronze chips, is a lot smaller on those.
Okay.
This, like, goes up halfway up the actual cart.
I can't wait to, like, put all those up on my wall.
Yeah.
Like, the foot-by-foot square of my collection.
The next screenshot is four people playing off two pads, which is... this basically just sums up everything that you're doing. The little small controllers are called Joy-Cons. That one's Joy-Con R for right, and then Joy-Con L for left.
Right.
So when you call and you go, hey, Nintendo, I need a Joy-Con R, holla at your boy. Because mine was stolen like a big lighter.
I just hate hearing holla at your boy
holla
from you.
Holla at your boy. Do you?
I do, yeah.
Hey, man, holla at your
I've
boy.
I've never heard it from you, and I hate it.
Holla at your boy.
I just want to bite your face. I hate it.
You want to bite my face?
We can move on.
Okay.
Makes me
I'll let
angry.
You bite my face.
And then you got the car stand.
Yep, the car stand accessory. The Switch Pro controller, which we talked about
right.
at length. It's got a little kickstand that'll break off in about 3 days. the Joy-Con grip, so that you can snap it into. It's got all the ergonomic, feeling good, battery charging stuff.
Yeah, man.
Then it shows four people playing multiplayer together, and then, of course, it being snapped back in. So, all the features.
Sure. One thing I don't see is one console hosting four people.
That's,
yes, but
we haven't really seen that.
We haven't seen that, but that's not necessarily something that you can see in a picture.
Sure.
Even when it shows four... If we took a shot of
my
all four of us
console only breaks into two parts.
Mario Kart. If there were four of us with DSs, and we were all playing Mario Kart, you wouldn't be able to tell if it was four people, four cartridges,
sure.
or four versions of the game. So, but that's a feature that they have touted in the past. So it makes sense that it would be in there, but this is Nintendo, so it makes sense that it wouldn't be in there.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. When you play Splatoon, you got to have two in the pink, one in the ink.
I like
Ooh.
That.
If you coined that, Mr. Kurtzen, I got to fucking...
Yeah.
If you didn't, we're going to rescind that later. But let's see. Uh-oh, you ain't fooling me with them pre-orders. Car stand, fuck it. Use duct tape. this is something that someone else, I think you guys actually discussed earlier. What will be the fate of the DS now?
So, I've heard rumors that they are going to just get rid of the DS stuff altogether. And the next handheld will just be some version of a Game Boy. A newer game.
Well, that this was to bridge the gap where it's like
it does
no more on either.
But I think that there has to be a more cost-effective model of a handheld. Granted, if they see that this is super successful, then they may not see the need for it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. My hope is that this is it. That they just do this, that there's no handheld. Because I don't want any developers like branching out across. I don't want Nintendo's first-party developers developing something for the handheld and something for the console.
Right, right.
I want all of that effort and energy. I want my Pokemans on that.
Yeah, I would love to see something like Advance Wars on a tablet or on a bigger screen that I can see. That would be great.
Or picture it this way. If there was nothing else, finally, Game Freak would be fucking forced to make a Pokemon game that is on a console.
Yeah.
That you can sit down and play. Imagine, you forced our hands. Or maybe this is the end of Pokemon. They're like, oh, I'm not going to do it.
Yeah, we're done with Pokemon. We know Pokemon Go is the most downloaded game for a digital device ever.
So, okay, so what is our next slide? Does it move on straight from...
No, it's more stuff. You can go to the next one.
Okay.
It's more
stuff. Because I'd like to give like overall impressions and some other stuff for you.
Nintendo, after showing the trailer, showed off a snapshot of some of their partners that they're working with. Some publishers, some developers.
Gotta get that hamster.
It's a large list. Seeing From Software and Bethesda on there, those are teams we've never seen making things for Nintendo. You have the important stuff like, you know, Atlus and Bandai Namco for all your Japanese games. You have Activision. You have Ubisoft on there. You have Square Enix. You have Sega. You have Platinum Games, who makes like that Transformers game that sucked, that Ninja Turtles game that sucked, that Korra game that sucked. But they also made Bayonetta. Yep.
I don't know.
Level 5, the guys who they they made Ni No Kuni. So, you know, that could be
okay.
We get something like that. So JRPGs type stuff. Codemasters makes racing games. Capcom, of course, like all the Resident Evil, Street Fighters.
I think I'm mostly excited about Epic and Unity.
Yeah.
Getting Unreal and Unity in there. Yeah. Like, I want to see some indie titles on this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, it's anything like the Wii U store. You will.
Warner Brothers, of course, does like the Batman series, Harry Potter games, Lord of the Rings, Shadow of Mordor. TT Games does all the Lego stuff. Telltale does, you know
Telltale.
Konami for all your pachinko machines or pachinko needs.
Right? Is Konami on there?
It is.
It is.
Ooh. So yeah, pretty much all the big hitters, and some not so big hitters. Even our boys at EA on there.
So, is this the last slide? Well, because I want to get like overall impressions.
I know, but
like,
do you want to talk about the partners at all? Is this interesting?
Well, my overall impressions encompasses everything. Including
this. I mean, even with this, the one partner that you guys were flouting immediately says, like, hey, we appreciated, like, working with you on it, but,
Bethesda.
Yeah, but, we haven't...
We don't have anything to announce.
Yeah, we know we showed Skyrim, like, 7 times, but we're not going to confirm that we actually have Skyrim running on this. Sorry, fellas. You know? Which is kind of strange. But, answer my question, is this the last next slide? Or,
go to the next slide.
Okay. So I do want to give like final impressions eventually.
So we already talked about Mario, so we don't really need to talk about it. I'm very excited. Yeah. But that's pretty much it. That's the last slide. So all right. Overall impressions.
Yeah, so look, here's the thing. I'll give mine first. Yeah. I don't know what I was expecting. Now, some things that were leaked were very cool sounding, right? Like haptic feedback in the actual joypads.
Which is something we don't know if they have yet.
Right. Exactly. I want to see a list of specs, like a list of features for this. I want to know about the virtual console. I want to know what they're going to do there. There's a lot of things that could make this super fucking great for me, right? Personally. Sure. But the way that it's shown in this, it's like, okay, and I've said this a couple times, it's a bunch of green eggs and ham scenarios. Like, you can play on a boat. You can play on a roof. You can play where, you know, it's like, but yeah, I'm pretty lame. I don't do those things really. So for me, this is like
on this couch and play.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it's like so. What is this new revolution? Is it going to be like? If it's not going to be revolutionary hardware wise, or like, you know, haptic feedback or anything like that, is it at least going to be like look better than everything else? No, but you get Mario games on it. All right, well then I'll fucking buy it. I mean, I have to, but like,
right.
But that's what it is basically to me. Though. Like, I get that to a lot of people, this might be. If you're going to go play on a roof, or you have a bunch of friends that you want to break your controller in half and play with, maybe, but that, none of that really fits to kind of scenarios that I will find myself in.
So, just a comment on that particular thing, like, that feature set that you're referring to. I think there are things that exist with consoles that we aren't into or interested in until they come to fruition. I think there are things that we don't know that we love or enjoy until it becomes the norm. Something like the achievement system. I remember when I worked at GameStop in 2005, and I was talking to people about the Xbox, Xbox 360, and I was talking about achievements. Like, no one cared. No one was interested in the idea that you accomplish things and get rewarded, and then that system is tied to the back end. That's not a system that people find enticing. But once it hit, it became a huge... Well,
I do hope that this will act as like a like some sort of milkshake and bring a bunch of boys into my yard that then I can play with. But currently, I just don't think it's going to happen.
I think that's fair.
So, you know, for me, this is like, oh, it's like the Wii U, but
that's what I'm saying is, it's things that you don't know that you want until you have. And I'm not saying that that's what this is going to be, guaranteed. Right. But I'm saying, have a little bit more faith. Because it potentially could be. Because, yes, you don't do those things now. Well, but look, having the ability to... I'm not saying that it's like, hey, DKP, let's fucking go to the park and play the Nintendo Switch.
I want
to
play this on a roof.
But what I am saying is that today, when Angry Tomato and Jay Dig Dug and Wesley and me, and we're all over here, it would have been so easy for us to all bring ours.
Right.
It'd be so simple for us to bring our individual Switches. Yeah. Feels good to say. So, I can almost guarantee you that every single time I come to your place, I will probably be bringing it. Like, 99% sure I will be bringing it.
Oh, good, because you ain't been bringing it lately, if you know what I mean. Give me them ribs. Yeah, it's your first ribs getting.
Go for it.
All right.
So, I think it's something that, like, yes, it's not something that right now I'm like, listen, I really miss having this.
It sounds like, okay.
You won't miss it until you
have. Here's like, they're selling this console on a very situational basis. And that's what I don't like about it. You know what I mean? Now, yeah, there could be so many features that we just don't know about.
Absolutely.
They're going to blow my fucking mind. But like, from the trailer we got, it's all this is very situational. Like,
absolutely.
Wouldn't you like to play games here and here and here? And if this happens and in this way, and it's like...
So, what I can say is that we... How long have we been streaming for? 56 minutes. Nearly 1 hour of content came from a 3-minute trailer.
Yeah.
So, the ability for us to have that much to talk about in a 3-minute trailer, do you think that we're going to get an hour of content out of this 1-minute trailer that we're about to watch with Red Dead?
No.
Like, there's not much there. So, and it's not necessarily, the goal isn't to compare this in the Red Dead trailer, but the goal is to say, like, yes, we didn't get a lot, but we also got a lot.
Well, like I said,
we got a whole lot.
I'm reserving judgment until I see the list of features
that it has. And I think that when you announce something like this, I think that when you, like, if you think about what this is, they may not have been able to show everything here. Are you guys listening to me or are y'all just reading all the comments? No, everybody's like staring at the comments.
I'm listening.
That's a mixture of both.
Okay.
You're on my deaf side.
I mean, we can just listen to read all the comments.
They're getting good, man. Stream.
They are getting good.
All right.
Middle guy.
I give up.
Everyone's a big fan of the ribs getting gone.
Oh, gotcha. Wow. That happens.
It's our selling
point. I don't know. I'm excited, but I'm remaining skeptical. Because if I let something get too hyped, it'll like, only disappoint
me. What if battery life's 2 hours?
Yeah.
And also, like, how many times have we been playing Wii U, right? And it's like, oh, shit, the gamepad's gonna die. Like,
right.
Yeah. And if you didn't have alternate control options, it's like, we gotta pause this shit out for a while, you know? Like, there's so many moving parts in this.
For sure.
You know, right. And that's...
There's a lot of potential for things not to
that
go
that we don't know anything about.
Yeah.
So, yeah. A couple comments, and then we'll get your last word on it.
Yeah,
we'll move on. Right. DKP wants boys. All right. Better believe it.
That's confirmed.
Mr. Kurtzen, too bad you don't install Grindr, baby. I've seen you on there. You got to take the middle guy to Kirby Lane. Nope. Fuck, I missed the opportunity to create a clip. I would play it at Rinfest Campout.
Yeah. If you want to.
I have a 3DS thing, you know, do it as well.
Right.
Came for the rib getting, was not disappoint. Yeah. It gives you two options. Options are good. Options are great, but I don't think it's a system seller, for me at least.
No.
Slowly we will fill Chainsaw with people who love Kirby Lane and just, I can read the rest of that shit. Fuck you, man. Bitches get switches. Seems like a meme that'll be relevant. Little boy ribs. Do you guys ever play b-ball under a bridge?
No, but I feel compelled to.
After watching,
fucking, I will now.
Right.
Thanks, Nintendo.
I can.
Hey, that's
I can make up my lack of skill on the streets.
Yeah, you can sneak this into a prison too. Text footer says that middle guy, ribs, major T ribs. I don't care as long as ribs get cut. let's see. I'm not gonna force bad habits. To quote Beck, comments are where it's at.
Where it's at.
Yay Spurs, it's just game.
Yay Spurs, it's just game.
It's just game.
He's only smells. He's nothing, just the smells. All right. Actually, there's a little bit more we need to go into. So a lot of this, since this is my last little topic here about this, so much of the hype around this has been, oh, there's an actual controller now. There's actual third party. It's to sum it up. We were watching a synopsis from Kind of Funny earlier or something. All this is a step in the right direction.
Yeah,
and it's like that's a sad thing. That's a sad thing. Like when you reveal, the most exciting thing about it is, well, it's a step in the right direction. Yeah. And you fucking up. That's not great in my opinion. It's not holy fuck. It's thank God they're not fucking it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
but that's. I think this it is a big deal that somebody's Nintendo. Going in the right direction. So when Microsoft announced the Xbox One, and it was all like TV, sports, use your Kinect to control this, and then they're like, you know what? We're going to focus on games. Our focus is on games. People were like, yay, the Xbox One is going in the right direction. When the PlayStation 4 said, we're focusing on games, we're focusing on the hardcore gamer. I know how much you love that term. When they show a focal point, when they show this is the direction we're going in, and people can connect with that direction, then yes, that's extremely exciting. And seeing Nintendo, the biggest, Reggie's Law, aggregate proponent of them all.
Well, the creators of.
The creators of Reggie's Law are going in the right direction.
We just gave it a name. They'd already done it.
Yes, it's impressive, and yes, it is one of the most exciting parts about this, is seeing a company like Nintendo going in a direction that is
not the Wii. It's like seeing your grandma on Facebook. It's great. It's like she's doing it. Look at her.
Look at your grandma putting that VR headset on.
It's incredible.
Speaking of which, everyone else is like, virtual reality! Nintendo's like, everyone likes Legos. Remember Legos? Here's a Lego console. Pretty much.
Essentially, yeah. So yeah, final point of mine, I'll remain till we know all the details.
Remain what?
Remain just like, eh, we'll see.
What do you TBD. Mean we'll see? Like, are you not going to buy it?
I'm not going to pre-order it.
Am I
going to
be happy about buying it? I'm not going to buy it. He got me by the balls knowing that any Metroids, any Zeldas, any Marios.
For sure. Yeah.
He got me by the balls. Like, what do you want me to say?
I'm not going to buy it until I see, first party titles out for
it. Well, the four, Tomato, you're buying it, right? Say yes so they can hear you on the mic. Or no, whichever.
This is wearing his
Jay Dig Dug.
Oh, yes.
You're going to buy it, right?
Fucking have to.
I'm definitely going to buy it.
I mean...
So everyone in this room, we're all going to be sitting here on the floor in a huddled in a circle playing it.
Fuck and
you're just
going to
be like watching.
I'm getting the chalkboard.
Fuck we will, man.
Competitive Splatoon, baby.
Dude, can I get us the eSports shirts?
Yes.
Yeah, we
that is your
team
job
shirts.
Requirement is get us the shirts.
So, I'll tell you this, you guys will not be here.
Regardless of the skepticism, you sold at least fucking four of them, Nintendo.
But that's not the point, though. It's like, oh man, I hate paying for car insurance, but gotta fucking do
oh,
it.
Oh, don't treat the fucking Switch like car insurance. Bro.
Oh, come on.
You got me by the balls, I got to.
Yeah.
What are the alternatives? I go to jail or don't play the new Mario?
Dude, like, if they were like, break. Hey, check out this new Mario game, and it was fucking a sequel to Super Mario 3D World or another side-scroller, I'd be like, no. This is not what I wanted. This is what I wanted. You could probably go back and watch the last 50 streams and you hear me being like, I want another sequel to fucking Mario Sunshine.
Dude, yeah, or Super Mario 64. Yeah, there's a billion streams that you said that.
Yes.
Because it's true.
And they're giving it to me, baby. All right, let's move on, because we've been on this topic for an hour.
So we got, I suppose us Martians are quite ready to make a comeback. Although, you wouldn't know it by this here trailer. Ain't nobody knows anything these days, except that you do see buffalo. Water buffalo.
You do see some water buffalo.
Buffalo, yeah. So it's got to be a prequel. You might see some Marston.
Are you sure on that?
Well, yeah, because in the original Red Dead, this riot theme where there were no more buffalo left.
Oh,
the end of the Wild West. This one's
good
a fuckload.
Very good.
So,
There's lots of buffalo.
And very much like a Magnificent Seven feel. Though we don't know jack shit from the trailer. That being said, if I was going to play any Wild West game, it would be this. Because god damn it.
What about Dead Hand? Or Dead Man's Hand?
Nope. If it takes place before John Marston is dead, I'm sure there will be some passing comment to it. Or a cameo or something.
I've seen people take screenshots of like the main four members of the gang. And it compares them to the seven people there. And it looks like those four people are in that gang.
Ah. It's beautiful. Like I said, we get nothing. This could easily just be a tech demo, really. Yeah. But,
I'm cool with that.
It's fucking incredible.
What do you mean, don't
get
anything? You get to drive a canoe.
You get to drive a canoe.
Point out, Mr. Angry Tomato just said you get to drive a canoe. All right. Keep moving.
Newest member of Chainsaw Hype, guys.
Drive a canoe.
Yeah. This is over. Tippy canoe. Drive a canoe.
See, it's basically like, hey, Old West rendered beautifully. And then, all right, listen, boy. When the shit hits the fan, don't run away like a pussy.
Yeah.
See you later. I don't know who the fuck's saying it, but we will know. That being said, this is the best thumbnail I've ever fucking seen.
No love for the PC folk.
Not yet, no.
Give it 6 months.
No love for the Switch folk either.
If I'm at. Why did they do it now? Why did they announce the game?
Why did they announce the game now?
Because that's Rockstar and they do whatever the fuck
basically,
they want.
Basically, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think they've ever revealed anything like E3.
Yeah, they never. Like, all of their trailers are just like, hey guys, here's a trailer.
They're like the rock and roll kids of something high.
I mean, it finally finished rendering, so they were just like, yeah, let's put it up tomorrow.
So, yeah, like I said, we there's not a whole lot to go over here. I mean, like, environment looks fucking incredible.
Yeah.
And if you actually look at the GTA 5 reveal trailer, which we did earlier, to see, like, maybe this is, like, a sort of bullshots scenario, right, where it looks really gritty, then it gets the downgrade, like Watch Dogs. Which, by the way, what's something I want to say? The Nintendo NX trailer was, like, based on Watch Dogs Society. All these cool folk. Anyways, hold on. Yeah, we know...
Give it up.
I can't. We know a little about it. I think like that's really exciting seeing exactly how fucking great it looks. And like I said, the original GTA 5 reveal trailer looked worse than the final product. So right. I don't think Rockstar is really too much into bullshots, really. So I do believe it'll look that good or better. All I want now is just to know if there's going to be more Martians in it, man. That's all I want to know.
I don't know. I want to know what type of like online play is going to look like. Am I going to be able to do some of the same things I can in GTA Online? Am I going to be able to buy a house? Am I going to be able to buy a train?
Buy a ranch?
Yeah.
Buy a boat?
Yeah, man.
Buy a train? Buy a plane?
I want a plane.
And play
in a boat?
And play a Switch on any of them?
Those green eggs and ham scenarios, man.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, I could see it coming out on PC just maybe a year later.
2019.
It'll probably come with a huge like texture resolution package that pumps it up even more if you handle it.
I assume it's based on the Euphoria engine, like GTA 5, or maybe an updated version of. Right.
Sure.
Probably. So yeah, modding will be easy and great.
Yeah.
Which will be fucking tremendous. So yeah, like I said, the fact that it's being made is great. Right? It's kind of like when Max Payne 4 got, or Max Payne 3 got released, revealed, it was like, alright, it's being made, I can sit back and relax now. Now that we keep getting pissed off that it's not happening. Or Shenmue 3. I want to know more about it, but yeah, I'm just happy to know that it's there.
Right.
Yeah. So yeah.
The big thing for me is how the campaign's going to play out. So, one of my favorite things that I thought we were going to see a lot more of after GTA 5 was a campaign that focused on multiple characters and gave you the ability to swap to any of those characters.
Considering there's seven, it probably will, which I didn't even think about that.
That's the question is, in the campaign, will you be switching between these seven characters? Will they all have an interesting story?
I want
and
to.
And are they all worth playing?
Unless yeah. John Marston is in the game. I only want to play as him.
You don't want to play as him? Or only
then I only want to play as him.
No, okay. Oh, yeah.
So I'm really curious to see if they're going to do something like that. And mission variety was one of the best parts about GTA 5. So I'm hoping that mission variety, like, sure. Granted, like, Rockstar North is who makes Grand Theft Auto, and Rockstar San Diego is who makes this. But there's bound to be some carryover. There's bound to be something that they learned.
They definitely talk to each other.
Yeah, and they've sold like 70 million copies of GTA. I don't know if it's quite that many, but it's getting
there. It's very well fucking could be.
So there had to be some lessons learned from each other.
Well, but they also sold the GTA 5 like 3 times.
Yeah, and they said, probably sold this one 3 times.
Well, they sold it to
last gen. I mean, we'll get the...
They sold it to current gen, and then they sold it to PC.
We'll get the Switch version in 2022. Right. So that'll be cool.
That'll be amazing.
4 years after this one.
Alright. So, yeah.
Yeah, I'm excited for it. The trailer was underwhelming to me, especially considering it came out an hour after...
Well, if you looked at the GTA 5 trailer, voiceover from one of the main characters, Michael, sort of from the very beginning, it set the game, set the feel of it, right?
Yeah.
This one, it's like tech demo. Here's how great it looks. Don't be a pussy when the shit hits the fan, boy. Red Dead Redemption 2. That's like all you hear. So, you know, you can draw very little from it as far as like the feel of the game. You're gonna play a good guy. You're going to play a bandit. It's a Magnificent Seven. There's seven of them. And that's, you. They're good guys in that, but. Who knows, you know?
Yeah.
You can draw very little from it. But I'm just happy to know that it exists.
Yep.
And 1 year from now.
Yeah.
Not bad.
Every other game, move the fuck out of the way.
Basically. Immediately.
You're not going to sell
a game. They want your EA disclaimer.
I work at EA.
Oh, yeah.
My opinions are my own. We're not even talking about an EA product right now. If we talk about EA, my opinions are my own. I work there. Ignore them. Don't listen to them.
You know, don't listen to him, period, especially about NX.
Whoa. That little bitch. I didn't make an X or the Switch. Exclamation EA.
We should do that.
No, we should totally do that.
Yeah. All right, so do you guys have anything else on this one here?
No, I just want to know more about it.
Exactly.
And that's really all it is.
What about the Martians?
They've gotten the hype train rolling, and you can see it starting in the trailer.
It's so beautiful. All right, fellas. Virtual reality. Fade a future.
So this is where we get into the segment portion of the show. We're just going to talk about a couple of different segments that are not related to announcements. This is just general discussion stuff. So finally got a PlayStation VR headset, and I probably spent about like 20 hours or so with it.
How do you
like
it?
Probably 25 hours with yours. I really like it. I mean, I talked about in the last episode, there are things that I prefer over the Vive, and there are things that I prefer with PSVR. Sure. PSVR is insanely comfortable. Super, super comfortable. And the games feel more complete. They feel more like games.
Okay.
And just being integrated into the PlayStation ecosystem by having achievements and going into the PlayStation menu. And it's all very simple.
Okay.
It's
easy to use.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice.
It's like a baby's first VR. It's very cool.
Now, are any of them games that you're doing right now, are they, like, stand up and move around?
No, because, I mean, there is stuff like Batman, where you can stand up, Job Simulator, where you can stand up, but primarily it recommends you sit down, just based on the way that the camera placement works, and it's one of the bigger issues comparatively to Vive. As you know, Vive has the room tracking, like, it's got the two things.
Right.
And you it tracks your room and scales it, and you can move around in that space. This is just one stationary camera that's getting a particular angle.
Right.
So the ability to, like, move around just isn't as strong.
Okay.
If you turn your back to it, it doesn't pick up the move controllers, so it just doesn't work.
Sure.
So that, I don't want to say it's frustrating, but comparatively speaking to Vive, it just doesn't feel as good. It's not, it's not as powerful, and it's not running on as powerful hardware, so the resolution isn't that great. But like I said, the games are significantly more complete. And it's way more comfortable. The way, like, the Vive, it puts all the weight on your face.
Right, this one feels more like a headband that you put on.
Exactly.
And then you've got the screen in front of you.
Right, in front of you, yeah. I like that much better.
Oh, yeah.
But I guess in terms of the topic, after spending a lot of time with it, I just want to talk about if you guys think it's a fad or the future? Meaning, do you think that it is another gimmick like motion controls? Or do you think that this has some legs and virtual reality will continue to be around and will continue to get iterations for the next 2, 5, 10, 15 years?
I don't know. I definitely think this version of virtual reality is a fad. Okay. I think just a visor and maybe some hand controls, that's not going to go anywhere.
Okay.
And it's like simulated virtual reality. You don't get any feedback if you pick something up. There's no weight there. If you get hit by something, you can't feel it.
Yeah.
You just have to like look around.
So do you think virtual reality has to be 100% immersive to work?
To work how you would want it to, yes. Otherwise, I feel like there's a disconnect and you can't really get...
That's actually a really good point. Like, one of the things that I notice with anybody's first experience, so, like, Job Simulator, for example. Mm-hmm. When you do the office one, there's a box of donuts. Everybody reaches in and grabs a donut, and they move it to their mouth, and then every single person who plays it opens their mouth in real life.
Sure.
They open their mouth in real life. The headset doesn't recognize that your mouth is open.
Nope.
The trackers don't recognize that your mouth is open. Your mouth is like not going to react in game. So, but you naturally just open your mouth like I'm eating donuts. And the same sort of thing can be said for the way that your hands interact. My mother-in-law tried it for the first time last night actually. And the first thing that she does is like puts her hands up to be able to see your hands.
Right.
But she's doing something that doesn't require a controller. It's just an experience. Mm-hmm. You just sit and watch.
Right.
But if she puts her hands out, she can't see your hands.
It's a very odd feeling.
Yeah. So there's a part, it's a game where you're in a tank and you're being dropped down into the ocean and a shark's attacking you. The shark comes at her and she like picks her legs up and like puts them on the chair. There's a bar in front of her. She reaches out to grab the bar.
Right.
Like she tries to interact with the world and it doesn't push
It's back. Not built for that.
Yeah. It's so I think that's actually a really good point.
Built to be like sat in like a movie kind of.
Yeah.
Except so, you can look around.
Yeah, I would almost say as far as like fad or future. Like look, what we have right now shows us kind of a proof of concept that we can go beyond Virtual Boy and go beyond it's Universal Studios.
For sure.
Universal Studios VR experience, which is horse shit.
Yeah.
You know, years ago. This is like, they have the immersion. They have like enough to trick the brain into, you know, doing this. Now, in order to make it a solid gaming experience, maybe not quite there yet.
They really need to figure out locomotion for that to work.
Yeah.
Sure. And then I've seen a lot of games coming out by indie developers where you almost ask yourself, why is this even in VR?
Yeah.
Like, if I have to ask that, there's no reason to use it at all.
For sure.
Other than just a gimmick.
I think one of the important things
that's,
is...
That's just going to come with flexing your muscles, though, as a developer.
Absolutely.
There is one game I was playing at the Austin Game Con where you're rock climbing.
Yeah.
And eventually you get so used to it with the Vive that you basically feel like Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Jumping around from stuff. And... That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
But...
I saw them.
You also... Cool. Like... The other turn of it was someone made a DJ system in the Vive where you can turn around, you have your entire music selection,
mm-hmm.
and you can do everything from faders to mixers and, like, jam out.
Yeah, he actually played a show
where,
like, the entire show, he used that software... To basically DJ at a club.
And it was cool.
Yeah.
Until he put on the wrong song and couldn't see the crowd just die and leave.
Oh.
Like, yeah. So.
I mean, like, the thing is, like, Valve especially, as much as this chaps my poor sensitive ass, we're not getting Half-Life 3. We're not getting Left 4 Dead 3. Well, we might, but they're going all in with VR. But that being a good thing is, in like, alright, so, you know, you're saying when you pick shit up, can't feel it.
Right.
They already have prototypes like that you can buy right now for developers that it's like a glove sort of thing where it kind of fits in the palm of your hands and has haptic feedback that when you pick stuff up, it's like you're actually picking it up. It has those pressure pads.
Sure.
Now, all that is basically, of course, proof of concept.
Mm-hmm.
But they are inching their way forward to the more immersive experience. Now, as far as like feeling like you're getting shot, that sounds pretty awesome, but I'm not sure if that would be for everybody.
Oh, no, definitely not. But even then, like, I've seen kits set up where it's four projectors above you, and you've got a kit that is a bunch of treadmills that push you back to the center when you walk on them. And you're playing Battlefield with a Kinect, and if someone is shooting you in a direction, there's paintball guns in that direction. So you can hear it whiz by.
That's great.
It's insane.
I'd love to have that job to shoot people.
No, it's all automated.
Oh.
It's all automated.
Let me be one of the guns.
They're overrunning. A couple of things I want to add. Number one, games as we know it, traditional video games, don't really work in virtual reality. They do to a certain extent. No. Like, there's a version of like Pong where you use your head to move it around and like hit the ball back.
I got sick as fuck playing Dark Souls 3 VR. I'm out of that end.
Oh yeah,
but like,
not good.
One of the things I've heard a lot of people talk about is like, man, now that GTA 5 you can go in a first person mode, I want to play that in VR. But it's going to make you really motion sick. Flipping in and out and around. It's just, it's not going to feel good to play. Because
bottom line is, like, from the beginning, you have to make your game to be a VR game.
Yes, right.
That is a very simply to point. Avoid motion sickness.
And so it's going to take a long time for developers to, you know, think about...
Use different muscles than they normally
what
use.
What needs to be done in order to make that a positive, good experience that's, like, enjoyable.
Yeah.
Because so far, it's a really young industry, and... We've all been working with a screen that's out here, and mostly a mouse and keyboard and a controller.
And that's kind of leading him into the other point is like we're at the precipice of what virtual reality is and what it can be.
Well, that's what we've said a lot. It's like
this is the beginning.
This is the shittiest it will get.
Yes,
it's
this
still
is Pong.
Pretty cool.
This is Pong when it comes to this is a black and white movie. This is like we're still in a black and white. Movie theaters. We
haven't
gotten
without a doubt.
Television yet. So I think the current iteration, it's like you were saying, the current iteration of virtual reality is a fad, but I also think it is the future.
I guess
I don't think it will replace a damn thing.
No, I don't think it'll replace
I won't be playing
anything.
With a controller in my hand
until
I can't hold it anymore.
I think that eventually it will, but it will be a long fucking time.
I think the main thing that's holding me back on believing in it is how many foreigners I was talking to about it at GDC this year and saying
you get the smirk on your face right now.
Yeah, it was mostly I can't commit an entire room to my video game.
For sure.
I can't commit an entire like even 5x5 foot square to video gaming.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what this type of VR makes you do.
Yeah.
So this is kind of a niche thing for us right now.
Five especially,
yeah.
Definitely. It's a definite luxury item.
So I could definitely see VR becoming a thing that people go to arcades for again.
Yeah.
If you have a really nice VR setup, going and doing that as a group would be a cool thing.
Batman asks, do you think Resident Evil 7 will cause motion sickness? 100% guaranteed yes.
I don't think so.
I mean, absolutely
for some people, some people just can't get over it. But I think, like I said, it depends on the developer and how they program it to make sure that they avoid it. This being like their flagship thing that you're going to play in fucking PSVR next year that we know about, I think they're going to go through as many hoops as fucking possible to make sure it doesn't.
Well, that kind of makes me wonder, either A, the game is developed for the purpose of playing in VR, and it will be way better in VR. And not be that great out of VR, or vice versa.
Well, that's the thing, though. Like you were mentioning earlier, the resolution.
Yeah.
Right? I came over to your place, and I played the Until Dawn simulator. The resolution was fucking awful.
Yeah.
It looked terrible. I was almost certain it looked better on the actual TV than it did in the headset. And Resident Evil 7 looks great, visually.
Yeah. Right.
But if it looks that much shittier in VR, I'd rather just play it on the fucking TV.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, that being said, like, I don't know, like, that could just be Until Dawn looked wonky on the headset. I don't know yet. We'll have to wait and see.
Yeah. Again, I think a lot of the motion sickness comes with locomotion. It comes with your body moving, not moving, but your brain thinking.
Yeah.
Anytime you're on an elevator or anytime, like, I was playing the Luge game where you're, like, going down a hill and you have to move your head. Anytime you hit a jump, your body, like, feels it. You can feel it in your stomach, like, you hitting that jump, so...
Because you, like, mentally prepare for it.
Yeah.
Without even thinking about it.
Yep. So, yeah. super interesting. I'm good on this. Anything else either you guys want to add before we move on?
I can't wait to see, like, how it gets better.
Yeah.
The future is more exciting.
I'm excited for it. I'm definitely skipping this generation.
Yeah.
That's fun. DKP or VR, oh god, nothing compares. Well, I mean, technically it is the best hard. I paid the money for it, so yeah. But I won't be getting RE7, I won't be getting the games that I want, and that's the trade-off.
Yeah.
Like, I'll be getting a shitload of tech demos, but I won't be getting the same games, so, you know, that I really want. So yeah, man. You take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and guess what you guys have? The facts of life. The facts of life. All right.
Midget, you do Extreme Beach Volleyball yet in VR? No. Have you?
No.
Oh, I would love to.
So.
Yeah, this is an interesting one.
Pre-orders. We're going to try to keep this short because we're getting up there. But general idea is, do you pre-order? What are your thoughts on pre-orders? Is there anybody that you feel like pre-ordering helps? If so, who is that and what's the benefit? And so, anybody want to go first?
I normally don't pre-order anything anymore.
And what's your reasoning behind that?
It's kind of just annoying seeing, like, this tech demo, or at least this announcement demo. If I go and throw money at it now, I don't honestly know what I'm getting until it comes out. I'm just sitting here out my money, hoping that it's a good one. And sure, I can throw that money to something else if I don't like it when it comes out, but I'm not about to just say, hey, I know what this is before buying it anymore.
So are you more of a cautious consumer than you used to be? Because you said you used to.
Yeah, I used to pre-order a lot of things. And then I was just like, oh, this wasn't exactly what I wanted it to be. And so I would take it back. So you've
had experiences of being let down.
Right, without a doubt. Buyer's remorse is a big thing that happens in video games. I do still look for a good Kickstarter to fund, though.
Yeah.
Indie games, I feel like it's okay if I can see that they've had prior success, or if I see that they've got decent people on their team that have had success and know what to look for. I can see, like, all right, they're probably going to go somewhere with it. Might as well see what comes of it.
Yeah.
I like funding the little guy, because I feel like if I ever wanted to do that, I would hope people would do that for me. And at the same time, you get to see some cool, weird stuff being made.
Definitely. I think a lot of, I don't want to say innovation, but a lot of creativity.
Yeah.
Comes from a lot of what they're doing. Mm-hmm. And also, you can get throwbacks. You can get, so as an example, I think one of the greatest Kickstarter games ever is Shovel Knight. Like one of the best side-scrolling platformers of the last 20 years, hands down.
Mm-hmm.
Something like Yooka-Laylee, which is like a revival of Banjo-Kazooie. Bloodstained, which is a revival of Castlevania. Mighty No. 9.
Shinmue 3, perhaps?
Shinmue 3, yeah. So
don't bring up Mighty No. 9.
I'm not going to. That was a joke slide comment. The ability to bring some of those back, yeah. All of those that I just mentioned, including Mighty No. 9, are games that I have kickstarted. Or giving him some of my screel.
Sure.
Because I'd buy into that idea almost as much or more than I buy into what I think the product will actually be. Mm. And sometimes you get Mighty No. 9 and sometimes you get Shovel Knight.
Sure.
That's about Kickstarter, though. As far as pre-order.
Yeah.
I'd like to move up to a comment.
I like the, I pre-order games so I can preload them if going digital.
Yeah.
I do that every once in a while, if I know I'm doing like DLC or something. Like, sure. I did that for the Destiny Rise of Iron.
Yeah.
Because I love that game.
Yeah, you want to play it as soon as it comes out.
Right.
I've VPN to play a game mode before. Now, here's my big point that Pepe said, depends on the game and the in game rewards I get by pre order. So,
okay.
Let's go back and just ask this question originally. All right, so. Back in the day, or let's just even say recently, Amiibos.
Mm-hmm.
Amiibo.
Why would you pre-order an Amiibo?
Get it.
Because what? There's a limited stock, correct?
Yeah, yeah. They purposely limit the stock.
All right.
Annoyingly. No, they don't.
So,
we're not going to get it.
Sure, okay.
Why would you, if I remember, why would you pre-order a digital game? There's no stock there.
It's all about access at that point. Or content.
Yeah, if I can preload a digital game that I've I already know that I want, I already know what it is.
Yeah.
Sure, I'll go for that. That way I can have it. I don't have to go wait in line or wait for it to download at midnight. I can just play it.
Yeah.
Right. I hate the idea that it's like, hey, if you don't do it right now, there are these things you're never gonna get.
Like, content wise?
Yes.
Like, yeah.
You can't get this skin.
I think that that's absolute fucking horseshit.
I gotta get this fucking Batman skin.
Right.
Yeah, I think that that's absolute fucking horseshit. And it's the same way in which it's like the Nintendo NX. I'm just keep calling that. I like that better. It's like, I'm gonna buy it anyway, it's gonna buy the fucking balls. You know why? Because you got Mario, you got Zelda. If there's ever gonna be a new Metroid,
right,
that's where it's going. You got me. No, I'm not happy about it.
Mm-hmm.
But you fucking do. And that's the same thing with pre-ordering. It's like, you want Mafia 3, right?
Yeah.
You want everything you can get out of it, right? Well, here's one-time offer. If you don't do it now, sorry, man, you're not going to get the full game experience. We might release the shit later for paid DLC, but there's no guarantee.
Ubi does some cool stuff where if you play in the game, you get rewards that you can unlock.
You play points or whatever.
Yeah, achievements. I like those. Yeah.
Just to touch on what you're talking about with, like, exclusive content, pretty much most games nowadays have it where, at least the big AAA games have it, where if you pre-order, you get exclusive content, like skins for your weapons or skins for your character or extra loot boxes or extra whatever kind of crates to be able to get more customizable fucking hats or whatever.
Always about the hats.
I'm the complete opposite. I have no interest in that stuff ever. Like, whatever the extra content is for Mafia, I pre-ordered that game, by the way, but it wasn't for the extra content, because whatever that stuff is, no interest in it whatsoever. I never have any interest in any of that type of, oh, if you pre-order this, you get the gold skin for
pre-order
your Lancer
from GameStop
rifle.
And get the double down docking dickhole Marie.
Well, what I hate is when they do pre-order from GameStop and get this one. Or pre-order it from Walmart to get this one.
Target for this, or Best Buy for this.
Yeah. Right. It's like, okay.
At that point, it's just like, alright.
Screw it.
Yeah. I'll just pre-order it from this particular place and, like, not get everything.
Like, the bottom line is, pre-ordering should be to reserve a copy to make sure that you want it. Yeah. If that's not an issue, there should be no fucking point. The consumer doesn't gain jack shit.
I mean,
right? I get the whole, like, you could preload it, right?
Right.
I get that, but, like, how about this? You can preload it if you want to or not.
Yeah.
But you can then only buy the license to fucking play it.
So
if you really want to buy it.
Let me talk about pre-ordering from a couple of different other perspectives. So from GameStop perspective, we actually were going to talk about this on last week's Prep Ape.
Mm-hmm.
So when PSVR came out, I was standing outside and the store manager came out. And Festus and I were waiting in line for PSVR. Well, kind of. We'd already gotten our pre-order and we were just waiting for him to open.
Sure.
And the store manager was outside talking to us, and I was like, hey, we're going to be talking about on our talk show pre-orders. So can you give me some perspective on why pre-orders are important for you guys? And the general idea is it gives them a general, like, roundabout of how much allocation to get.
Mm-hmm.
So it helps them determine how many they need.
Mm-hmm.
And it also is, from their perspective, a guaranteed sale at that particular retailer.
Cool.
So to help that retailer stay in business, it helps them. And then on an even more personal level for the employees, it's a number. It's a metric that they have.
I think it's great that you help the retailer, but
But I'm talking about from the perspective of the retailer.
No, but even at a grander scale, from the perspective of GameStop as a total, they take that pre-order money and they just put it in a bank and they short sell that money. They put that in stocks and short sell it and make hella profit off of it.
Absolutely, they do. So yeah, that makes perfect sense though. Like if GameStop, if I was GameStop the corporation, fuck yeah, I'm doing that.
Right.
And it's a brilliant, like, money-making idea. So if it's like, hey, let's spend, I don't know, $50,000 on pre-order content. Let's print, you know, a million of these posters and let's print all these things that will cost us a fraction of the cost to be able to do that. And yeah, it's worth it. And then from the perspective of a developer or publisher, it's how you can help build excitement or enthusiasm for your game. It's how you can say that, hey, this is what, so like if you talk about PlayStation VR, before it came out, they said, we have sold out X amount of pre-orders. So we know to expect X amount of sales. So we can project this, which can help our stock, our shareholders.
Right, but that goes, sorry, you go on.
It also helps them kind of at least set a baseline of where to set their server status at.
Yeah, absolutely.
For server load.
That's a very big point.
So launches come out decent.
Yeah.
Or you could do betas. Or demos.
Whoa. Yeah, but a beta is
Oh, I know, whoa, right?
Calm down there.
But man, a beta doesn't give you a general idea.
Concept.
A beta is just like, it's a demo. It gives you an opportunity to test something. It doesn't mean that you're going to buy that thing.
Sure.
Yeah, but you have a bigger load of people playing a free fucking demo to test your shit than you will pre-orders.
Yeah.
Potentially.
So if it's too... Yeah. So, listen, there's no fucking reason, as a consumer...
Yeah, this is an important note.
Ever,
is
this, ever.
These are all
fucking pre-order game, unless it's like, I don't think it's going to be available.
Right.
When I want it.
Like Jonathan says, since the introduction of pre-orders, guess what other phenomenon arose? Artificial scarcity.
Yeah. So, here's the thing. Unfortunately, I pre-order certain games if I want the fucking content or whatever.
Yeah.
Or like Batman, if I really want, if I want to be able to play it on release. Like, at the moment it released.
Sure.
I get it. I'm a hypocrite. I'm saying this is a shitty practice. And I'm, helping it.
Vote with your wallet.
You know? I'll be the first person to say I'm a hypocrite. Fine. Fuck it. But, I do think it's a very shitty practice. It's anti-consumer. Big time. Look at No Man's Sky. For fuck's sake.
If there's anybody I'm blaming on that, that's marketing. The way that game is.
Without a doubt.
But look at those people that are like, hey, make sure you pre-order it, though. Pre-order it. All those people that pre-ordered it got fucked. They can't get refunds.
All the people that bought it got fucked. Not just the people that pre-ordered
it. I know, but I mean like...
And yeah, you can cancel pre-orders.
Once again, I understand that you can. My point is, there should be zero reason as a consumer to do that. Except unless the content's not going to be there for you when you want it. Now, the pre-order incentives, I think, are fucking horrendous practice.
Yeah.
Who
the fuck wants to be incentivized to do something? Not this guy.
Oh, man. Good thing I bought this game on their terms, so I can get all the fucking content. Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm saying, from the perspective of content. Shit. So, generally speaking, for me personally, I pre-order a metric ton of stuff. I pre-order all the time. I definitely pre-order hardware. Hardware is always the most, like, PSVR, I was outside waiting in line just to pre-order it. You best fucking believe I'm going to wait in line to pre-order the Switch. As soon as they're like, we're taking Switch pre-orders on this date and this time and this place, I'm going to fucking be there.
Right.
Like, hey guys, I'll be late to work today. I'm going to fucking GameStop to make sure I can get my pre-order.
I guess pre-ordering a hardware system is a little bit different.
But software, multiple reasons I do that. Number one, I like to pay something off. I like to put the money towards it. It's like a layaway program. So if it's, so as an example, I had a few extra $100 and I was like, okay, what could I spend this money on? And I was like, oh wait, there's a shitload of PSVR games coming out in like 4 months.
Right.
So I paid off my PSVR and I pre-ordered like Batman Arkham VR and I like pre-ordered and paid off several games. So when it came out, it was money that, was ready to go. Granted, yes, that is because I am bad at budgeting. So it is a personal thing. It's not like I was better with money, I could have just saved the money. And
look, that's fine and great that you do it that way. But here's the thing. It's if you didn't, you might be penalized for not. There's content you won't get. You won't be able to play it on release. Also, like, if you just want to pay off the game early, fine. But for developers to be able to incentivize them, pre-order now at one retailer or another, or, that's like worst case scenario.
Yeah, sure.
And get this. It's fucked. Absolutely fucked.
Yeah.
And then the final reason that I personally pre-order is it helps me establish a really great relationship with the employees at GameStop. And I know that sounds really stupid, but when you say to the GameStop employee, hey, I'm going to pre-order this and whatever, it helps you guys out. They call me every single time before games come out. If there's something in particular, it's like, hey, I want to see if I can get this particular version of this game. Like, I don't want it in a steel case. Sure. Or I want, hey, you guys have Mario 3D World on the shelf and it comes in a red case, but I want to get it in a blue case. Would you guys be willing to let me swap out the art?
Sure.
Like, basically, if you build a relationship with the employees, they will take care of you. It's like any, like, it's, I know it's GameStop, but it's like a small business. You, like, pay, you give them your time, you give them your money, you show your dedication
to
them.
Dude, that should not be a good consumer reason for fucking...
It's not a good consumer reason. This has nothing to do with consumers. This has to do with me. This is a reason that I personally choose to
do. Fair enough.
I choose to do these things because I like how it helps me. I can build a relationship with the GameStop employees, and I can have conversations with them that will allow me to be able to do things.
So you're trying easier. To work their system.
So yeah, absolutely. It's a manipulation technique.
Sure.
So when the Switch pre-orders come out, all of you guys are going to be looking up information, and GameStop will be calling me saying, hey, we'll be taking pre-orders at this date and this time. I went ahead and put you on the list. Like, there are added benefits to being able to do something like this. Mm-hmm. And is it worth it?
Off the books benefits. Huh?
Yep.
All right.
Nice. Anything else on pre-orders?
I think they could be better.
Like, incentive-wise?
Like, I don't even know how they could be better yet, because I haven't put that much thought into it other than I've just kind of tried to stop doing it.
Okay.
But I think if we let marketing teams kind of put a leash on them and say, like, whoa, don't say this will be the greatest game ever. Like,
yeah.
Be honest about it.
Yeah.
Know that it's still in development 3 years out. For and sure. A lot of things could still change.
I think marketing is one of the biggest issues with games. I think it's a bigger issue than probably most other things wrong with games.
Yep.
And as if your job is to market a game, you best believe you're going to try to manipulate mm-hmm. players into buying or getting excited about something that they can't actually speak to.
Right. Living the dream, man. So before you know if a game's good, make sure you put down that money beforehand. Otherwise, exactly. Fuck you.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, it's... What are you going to do, man? Catch by the balls?
Yeah.
Or...
I like Kurt's comment. I want to walk into Major Tom's GameStop and tell them, I'll pre-order 50 games if you stop looking Major Tom.
Yeah, get that bitch. All right, we're at an hour 40, so let's move on to... We got one more, and then Ask the Apes, and I think we're good.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, here's the other kind of big one.
Digital or physical?
Oh.
What do you do and why?
Can I say both?
Yes.
Then both.
Good reasons.
Both. Digital, I like just having it preloaded. I like being able to just start playing at midnight. I like being able to know that it's already installed, not have to worry about their servers, like, shitting themselves while everyone else tries to download them. Preloading is probably the main reason why I go digital. Plus, I just moved, like, across the country, and I was not able to bring all of this collection that you've got going on here. But my entire Steam library fits on an SSD pretty nicely. And I can just download that now that I've set up here.
Yeah.
I can just bring it in. Delete it if I don't need it anymore, but know that I still have access to it. Physical. Most of the older games that I love, I still have physical copies of. And then sometimes if it's got a nice box, a nice, like, special edition thing, I'll try and buy that. If it's for a game that looks awesome or a game that I personally have an attachment to.
Yeah.
I like all those collectors.
There's a lot of five versions bought. This console.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's the thing. But the real scare between digital v physical is my Steam library. If Steam goes under, they're fucking gone, man. That's it.
Yeah. No, I completely agree. Or, I mean, even more on top of that, if Steam turns dirty, I've bought leases to all of my video games on Steam. I don't actually own them. So if they just want to say, oh yeah, that's not there anymore, I could never download it again through Steam. But, I mean, that's kind of the trade-off.
Well, sure. You know, the thing is, like, which one would I prefer? Obviously physical. However, that being said, like, where's the market going? Not that direction.
No.
So what choice do we really have in it? Fucking pretty much zero.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of unfortunate.
I mean, you have a choice. You can buy physical. You can be a part. You can vote,
quote-unquote,
with your wallet by spending money on physical media still.
Sure.
By showing, not being a part of that trend that's going in that direction. Not to say that you can have an impact on it.
So let me ask you this.
But you can.
Let me ask you this. If the Nintendo Switch was digital only, would you buy it?
Of course I would.
So there you go. You ain't gonna make a fucking
Arguing with you in context of saying I have a problem with digital. Like, I don't have a problem with digital. I think digital's fine.
Yeah, I think digital's great because it allows a lot of even smaller devs to push their product out to a large market.
I don't think it's a problem. What I'm saying is the idea that there is a product that you hypothetically won't you purchased that maybe everybody hypothetically won't be able to, like PT, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
There's no physical copies of PT floating around.
No.
They just had to remove it, and if there will be a day when all PS4s fucking break or some shit, it's nobody can play anymore.
Yeah.
Or, that's fucking, I guess not technically true. People have modded over to PC, etc., right?
Right.
For preservation purposes. But, that game, as its original, right, like, it's not this thing you can hold. Right? They said, we're gonna remove it. Another example would be Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Disney acquired Marvel, and they're like, oh, we don't want to sell that anymore on Xbox Live Arcade and all sure. that. So they removed it. People already had it downloaded, great, but that's fucking it, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, it's... You're literally losing, potentially losing art, content, whatever you consider games, right? Definitely a form of art. But you're putting that in a very fragile environment. Where if it licensing issues or servers, it could make it completely 100% unplayable.
I mean, at that point, if you're going to want to find it, it'll be found online.
So
you would hope.
Let's talk about in terms of convenience then, because I know DKP, like your 3DS and your Wii U are digital only libraries. And is that?
I own physically most of the games that I bought on them, though. Like, on Virtual Console, I own every single one of them.
On Virtual Console, yes. Yeah. But the ones that aren't on Virtual Console.
You mean Animal Crossing New Leaf?
Animal Crossing New Leaf.
I enjoy that
Metroid
game.
Metroid Prime Federation Force. Super Mario 3D Land.
Yeah, you know, those are games I'm
Donkey
willing...
Kong Country Tropical Freeze.
Those are games I'm willing
Super
to
Mario
lose.
Maker.
I won't be happy about them, but yeah.
So the reason that you got the digital versions, though, is a convenience factor, right?
Right, but like... If we're here to, I don't know what we're here for. Are we painting like pros and cons, or are we saying like which one is?
We're talking about both, digital versus physical.
Right.
The purpose is to have, I mean, the fucking topic says digital versus physical fight. Like, yeah. The purpose is to discuss the pros and cons, which one you do, why you think one's better.
Look, I'm not, digital like, would be absolutely perfect.
I just don't want you to say that like you only go physical.
Well, no.
Or
I'd go both.
That you have a problem with it, but you are comfortable with going digital.
Digital would be absolutely perfect. If there was a guarantee, they would always be available. That's the problem.
Sure.
And that's the only thing you can get from physical.
For sure.
With the exception of deteriorating hardware components, right?
Sure. Yeah, definitely.
Anything else? I want to close out my comments on it, and then we'll move on before anything else you want to add. Before we...
No, go for it.
Okay. I prefer physical.
Well, I did want to...
I prefer physical as well. I like having a physical game. But I do recognize that we are going into a digital age, and I'm very comfortable with that. I wasn't comfortable with music when it did it, and then I got comfortable with it. I wasn't comfortable with movies when it started doing it, and now I'm comfortable with it. So just give it time, and it will become the norm, just like it is with music and movies. But as of right now, I still do like to own physical games, especially for any Zelda games. Like, I just got rid of a huge chunk of my Wii U games because I've started buying a bunch of them digitally. And all my Zeldas, I still kept all of those. So my 3DS carts that are Zelda, my DS carts, anything that's Zelda, I kept. So there's it depends on the particular product for me. Like Xbox One, I have a digital-only library. But that is a concern that I will lose it, and it's also a concern about hard drive space. Sure. Even when we talk about the Switch, and we're talking about how big is the hard drive, is it 32 gig, is it 100 gig, is it 500, a terabyte? Yeah. I want to make sure that I have enough space, so...
Better be something decent.
Yeah,
because absolutely. Games are too big these days.
Definitely.
I say too big loosely. Like 60 gigs.
Yeah.
Roughly.
So, yeah. That's pretty much it. I'm comfortable with it, but I'm kind of whatever about it.
Yeah.
Normally, I would be a lot more energetic about this topic, but I've been sick this week.
And we've been going for nearly 2 hours.
Yeah. I'm petering out. So let's get to Ask Apes Anything, right. Which is the best and most and fun segment.
JD, do we need to follow up?
Do you hear what I just said? Most and fun segment. That's great, man.
You're good.
Okay, cool. Thanks.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Alright guys, so if you go to facebook.com/group/thechainsaw8group, you can post your questions in the pinned post. So I'm going to go through those really quickly, and we're going to call it a night. So,
alright.
First question is...
You're an 8 now. I'll peanut guy for a second.
What are you most looking forward to seeing at the PlayStation conference? This is VKP that asked this.
Probably new VR games.
Yeah. New VR games. This I heard a rumor that they have about 200 in the work, and I want to see all of them.
Yeah.
I want to see what they've got going on.
My favorite thing about PSX last year was like seeing and talking to all the people in the industry that I like.
Oh sure.
Follow. So different like the game trailers guys. I met a few of them last year. They're easy allies now.
Okay.
Their very first meet and greet is happening at PSX. I'm super excited. Like all nine of them are going to be there.
Nice.
I met the Kinda Funny guys last year. That was really cool. I met KG Inafune. Mm-hmm. I met David Jaffe. I just met like really cool people. I met, what's his name? The director, Neil Druckmann. I met Neil Druckmann, who directed The Last of Us and the Uncharted games, mm-hmm. or at least 2 and 4. So getting to meet them and talk to them, like I got to ask Neil Druckmann about The Last of Us movie. He's like, yeah, that's probably not. So, and I haven't read that or seen that anywhere. So it was cool, like having a conversation with him about it. So getting an opportunity to do that again and meet newer people or people I didn't get a chance to see last time.
Are you going?
Oh, yeah.
Very fun. Yeah, no.
Thank you. All the apes are going?
Yeah, all the apes are going except for J-Dig.
Oh.
Nice. Where's it at?
It's in Anaheim this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
That'll be fun.
Yeah, it should be a good time. Mr. Kurtzen asks, will we have to copy the questions from Pep851 to this, or will you just read them from both posts? I didn't copy them over, even though I said that I would, but if we have time, I'll go back and grab them. Uncle Gandhi says, what do you think Red Dead Redemption 2 will be? What would you like to see? So this question
John
was asked
Marston.
On Tuesday before we actually...
Well, I gotta say.
What would you like to see out of Red Dead? We'll just make that answer real quick.
I like an actual, like, small town to visit. I know there's, like, a small one in Red Dead 1. Sure.
You mean more like Los Santos, like an overarching, like, area that feels...
A populated area.
Something, yeah, something that feels populated. It's actually, like, the world is moving, not just very standstillish.
I really liked the heist mechanic that they brought in with GTA 5, and I would love to see them do something like that.
Them train robberies, boys.
Yeah, ooh. Yeah, something like that would be great.
It's gonna be like, what is it, Grand Theft Auto 3, San Andreas, where you're gonna get stuck on the train the whole time, just hate it.
Classic.
All you had to do was follow the damn train, CJ!
I've already said it before, but I would like to see multiple characters and a lot of mission variety.
Yeah.
Next question. How long until a killer app is released for VR? I'm talking system seller, like Mario 64, PS2's MGS2, or Xbox's Halo. I just realized that this generation didn't really have any system sellers until Bloodborne came out for PS4.
You'll know it when you see it, I think.
Yeah,
there's really no guessing.
Probably next year, because we got Doom VR. I'm sure Skyrim's getting VR.
Yeah, but to me, like I said earlier, the games that are already games are not the greatest games in VR.
Right.
Yeah. Like,
something that's already a game in VR does not necessarily make it a great game. I think it's something that we don't know exists.
I mean, they're like fixing it for VR, though. You know, I have hopes. Because they're like editing it for VR.
Yeah, but you're going to be teleporting around and stuff. Yeah. Not that that's going to be bad, but it's not going to be killer app.
Doom, you have like a super run.
Then it's going to have a locomotion issue. So, I mean, time will tell. Senpai asks, what versus movie would you like to be made? Like Freddy versus Jason, Batman versus Superman, Wolverine versus Hulk, etc.
Good question, Senpai.
Yeah, that's a great question. I would say probably I'd love to see... I don't know. That Hulk vs. Wolverine sounds fun.
Yeah.
That's already out.
Because,
well, not like live action.
Yeah, no.
I remember when there were rumors of Freddy versus Jason versus Ash from Evil Dead. I'd really like that.
My answer is one of two things. It's either Bruce Campbell v. Killer Clowns from Outer Space, nice. Or Bruce Campbell v. Freddy Krueger.
Cool.
Imagine the hilarity with both that turned into horror comedy at some point, right?
Yeah.
Tremendous.
Idify says, the trailer for Logan, yay or nay?
Yay.
Nah. It does not feel like an X-Men.
Yay or nay?
Yay.
Okay.
I'm happy to...
No, it feels like Old Man Logan.
I'll give my opinions, but you're the new ape here, man.
I'm saying nay, because it just seems very mediocre. It's not Old Man Logan that I loved.
Sure.
And it's just like, let's just shove X-23 in there.
It's just Logan, it ain't Old Man Logan.
Yeah.
It's The Last of Us.
But it did feel like The Last of Us. Like, we'll actually see a very human side, which
Hello, girl.
You don't see. Which, yeah. It's either going to be, when they're doing it that way, it's either going to be absolutely fucking horrendous, or really fucking good. Who knows? Yeah. That being said, one last thing on that. It did break my heart to hear Patrick Stewart sound like he was dying.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I'm excited about that. That was actually my favorite part. I didn't realize he was in it.
Just Papa Logan.
Next question from I-5, Volume 2 of Guardians of the Galaxy. Thoughts? And can Baby Groot get any cuter?
No.
I don't think he can get any cuter. I'm excited for it. Apparently it takes place like just a few months after the first one. So that could be very cool as far as seeing what happens with the like overarching plot.
Yeah.
I'll be excited to see what the new storyline wise.
Yeah.
Because I think it's coming out before Infinity War, right?
I think so.
Yes.
Okay.
Hillary Clinton, the girl from Precious.
That's pretty much all I'm waiting for, is this Thanos to come in.
Right. I want to see him do something.
Yeah. I-Defy says, the song Dancing With Myself, gay or not?
Billy Idol? Not.
Not.
I don't think so.
No. I'll say no.
Yeah.
This is I-Defy as well. 2017 looks like it's going to be a hectic year for gaming. What's your most anticipated game for 2017?
Red Dead 2, baby! Red Dead 2!
You know, if this was a year ago,
I'm excited for the new Mario.
I say, if the Mario comes out in 2017, Mario. Besides that, not a lot has been announced for like 2017. Well, like a lot's been announced, but like, we don't know a shit ton about it. Oh, I forgot about Persona.
Horizon Zero Dawn.
Red Dead 2.
I don't care about Horizon. Resident Evil 7 as well.
I-Defy says, 2017 looks like it's going to be a hectic year for movies. What 2017 movie are you looking forward to and why?
Infinity War.
Goodfellas 2. Goodfellas 2.
I can't think of a lot of them, so I'm just going to say Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Yes. Not over Avengers?
I kind of want to.
Avengers is coming next year too, right?
Isn't Justice League coming out?
Yeah, Justice League is next year.
Pretty stoked for that, yeah.
I feel like that's way too early.
My legit answer would be It, the movie remake.
Oh, and Halo Wars too, as Kurt Sames said.
Oh, Halo Wars is coming out, yeah.
I'll be able to play it on PC.
Yes.
Mr. Kirsten asks, will you be able to watch porn on the Switch? You fucking better be able to.
Yeah, dude, they better have an internet browser.
Yeah, there's got to be an internet browser.
Infinity War's not next year. So yeah, Guardians
of the Galaxy. If I can watch porn on my Dreamcast,
Wonder Woman.
I better be able to, yeah.
I-Defy asks, how excited is DKP for Madea Scared Stupid?
I can't wait to see Ernest. Never mind, I'm not even in here.
Yeah, right.
Mr. Kirsten asks, do you think the cartridges will cost more than your normal game?
I don't think so.
No.
That's just a terrible marketing
Less,
thing to do that.
If anything. If Nintendo would be great if they held to their $40 games or $50 games.
It'll be 50.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
Because they're going to be like really big SSD cards.
It won't be more, though, I don't think at all.
I don't think that would be smart.
I-Defy7 asks, so now that Angry Tomato is part of the Chainsaw Ape family, is he going to bring his many viewers over? LMAO?
He already does.
I already do. I bring all one of them, baby.
Mr. Kurtzen asks, do you think the Switch will allow violent games rated M and whatnot on the system?
I sure hope so.
Yes.
With the amount of developers they have listed, yes.
Yeah.
Mr. Kurtzen asks, what if Nintendo accidentally breached a contract with Bethesda when they showed off Skyrim on the console, and Bethesda ends up pulling the game?
Reggie's Law!
I'll just leave it at that. That's too good of an answer.
Yeah.
Texas Phil Davis asks, how much do you think the fans influenced Rockstar to make a new Red Dead for next gen, or was it planned all along? Planned all along.
Yeah, I think it was planned all along, but...
If fans equals sales,
yeah.
If you are equating fans to sales, then yes, they had a lot to do with it.
Right.
Yeah, I think the fans has influenced the shit out of it.
Yeah. Sales, particularly.
Yeah.
The game sold really well, so they made another one. Because they're a business, after all. Mr. Kirsten requests, can you call your dad and confess to stealing his lube and breaking his porno VHS?
We'll advertise that beforehand. And
maybe
yes,
we'll do it during the 24-hour stream.
Oh, that'll be
pretty good.
We'll advertise it beforehand. Everyone will know when it is. And it'll be a highlight when we do.
Cool. Mr. Kirsten asks, is there any more surprise guests coming on? We got Val, Fetus, and a middle guy in 1 month. You treat us too good. Time will tell.
Yeah.
Well, now that I'm streaming...
As of right now, I don't think there are any plans.
Now that I'm streaming, the wife might pop on occasionally.
There you go.
I don't know that's much of a surprise, though.
Morning Shark asks, do you think the controllers on the Switch are directly connected to the tablet somehow? There was a moment where multiple tablets and controllers were in use. What if they were accidentally switched?
Well, that's a good point. If, like, if I give you my right controller and you put that on your console, I imagine when you slip it into the gamepad holder thing,
I would hope it automatically syncs it. That would be so nice.
Because I'd hate to mess around with Bluetooth just to get that working.
Kurtzen copied the questions over for us. Thanks, Kurt. This is from last week. Has Fetus taken a shower since arriving in Austin? He has, yes. This was last week. So, Idify says, how much hand sanitizer do you guys go through when Fetus is in town? Same amount as normal. When Fetus finally does take a shower, what kind of decontamination process do you guys perform?
Dude, how gross is Fetus?
Delousing, specifically.
Mr. Kurtzen asks, how can I get Major Tom to say the whole EA thing without getting him in trouble? Just by asking.
I guess he looks dirty.
Texas Davis says, what's the story with this Fetus feller? Where did he come from? He and I worked at Freebirds together.
Alright.
Starting in like 2008. Then we moved in. He moved in with me and my wife, and we became roommates, and then we became really good friends, and then he moved to... We did the podcast with me and DKP for a while. Then he moved back to Houston. That's where he's from. That's it.
It's unfortunate.
Tixville David says, everyone needs to know, how does porn work on PSVR? Can you open the internet browser and pull up some websites? I don't think you can pull up websites. I think there's a particular website that you can go to that will play them through the media player of the PlayStation 4. I haven't personally tried it, but they were talking about it on PS I Love You.
Yeah, I don't think you'll get like the full PS. I don't think you'll get the whole VR porn experience.
I think it is, yeah.
You don't get to see all the giant women.
I'll have to try it out and let you guys know.
Oh, the small ones.
Like that GBH song, Big Women? Big Women!
Texville Davis says, did y'all hear about the Steam bringing native DualShock 4 support for PC?
Yeah.
Thoughts? Better than Xbox controller?
Yes. I like the Xbox better.
I've always liked the Xbox controller more.
PS4, baby.
It kind of depends on what game I'm playing. But, like, action games for, like, the Xbox controller. But if it's, like, an RPG, it's for the PlayStation.
Yeah.
DKP?
Yes.
PS4?
Yes.
Okay. Kurtzen asks, Still Ozer said rank doesn't matter. Does rank matter?
And what?
No!
I like rank. I like
it matters
games.
To individuals on a personal level. It's subjective.
I like competitive games. So I like ranks.
Yeah.
Texas Phil Davis says, everyone needs to know, how does porn work? Oh, we already answered that. Kirsten asks, would you notice if I delete my questions while you're in the middle of reading them? Will it mess you up?
Yes.
I mean, possibly. Not if we screenshot it ahead of time.
Somebody else is writing a comment, and when that comment pops up, that will be the last comment.
St. Isler's?
Waiting. Want to take a moment to say, Wesley, thank you for joining us.
Oh, thank you so much.
Insightful.
Thank you for having me. It was great.
You did a very good job.
Yeah. Hey, I tried.
Much better than Fetus.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because, well, Fetus, in the last episode, he got Saint Iloser. Iloser.
Stiloser?
Oh, I stole it. No, cool. Thanks, Kurt. We're done with Ask Apes Anything. Yeah, thank you for joining us.
Cool, yeah, it was fun.
Yeah.
Thanks for making me officially part of Chainsaw.
Thanks for asking.
Guys, let's bring it in.
Good episode.
I'll clap myself.
This is episode 52. We have officially made it to 1 year's worth of episodes. Woo. We've been going longer than a year because we just miss weeks sometimes. But I really appreciate you guys that have stuck through it. Miss Major T, what you playing? Major T, Tumblr. Miss Major T, you know you left the TV on. Major T, shit.
Hey, PS.
thanks, guys, for hanging out. I think we're pretty much done. Is there anything else? Any other slides? I don't think I have a closing slide.
Wait, did you guys do Win Stuff
Money?
No,
certainly don't.
Nope, they got rid of it, man.
Oh, I don't.
Win Stuff Money's over.
We cut Win Stuff Money.
We're putting that back into the stream. We'll go over that with you later.
My bad, teams.
Yeah.
Thanks for hanging out. Make sure you guys join us tomorrow night for DKP stream.
Cool.
I'll be going live on Sunday.
Daddy's lap's open.
Angry Tomato, are you streaming on Saturday as your first official stream?
Oh, I know. We'll be at Six Flags.
Oh,
sweet.
Well,
I'm going to
Six
Flags.
He's already missing his first stream.
Well, there, man in the middle, as we see, that is a Twitch account. Fantastic fella.
Yes.
Give him a follow.
Yeah. Brilliant. Yeah, thanks, guys.
Stop gyrating.
You got a Twitter account?
Like,
can they follow you on the Twitters?
It's the same handle.
Cool. So follow him on Twitter at @Wright_here.
You should be able to find it all on that page.
Something interesting about you. Something that we both learned.
Oh, what about it?
Tell us about it.
The hearing aid or...
Whichever. Whatever you feel the most comfortable talking about.
I mean, yeah, the hearing aid. I was born with my right ear just not there. So I was born without it. It's a thing called microtia. So all of this is fake. It's actually made out of my ribs.
Well, that's pretty good fake.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet, but there's no ear canal. So I've got a cochlear implant, which you guys might have seen. It's kind of cool.
It reverberates sound through your skull.
Yeah, right?
So I can like cover my ears and you can put it on my head and I can hear better.
You want to try it?
Sure.
All right.
It's fucking...
Oh,
it's up. Yeah. And so this is how I talk. Or this is how I hear, really. It's pretty wild, right?
Cool, you're not
right?
hearing with your ears, you're hearing with your skull.
So the way it works is it shakes, and then when it's pressed against your skull rattles, which rattles the bones in your ears, which simulates hearing the same way.
It's fucking awesome.
Yeah, it's cool.
Fucking witchcraft.
It's a fun party trick. So I can
Davis is fucking awesome.
I can also do like... I've got a magnet drilled into my skull, which is what it connects to.
So you got a beer cap there right now.
Yeah. Pretty cool.
Dream, man.
Yeah, man. That's my life.
Pretty awesome.
I'm a cyborg, pretty much.
Again, thank you guys for hanging out. I'm Major Tom.
Wesley Wright.
Old Senpai.
DKP.
And we out!
Later, fellas! Go fuck all your mothers. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. It's still on.
It's still going.
I control this.
It's still on.
It's still going.
It's still on.